Hi Libra, this is part two of your weekly readings for the third week of July. Okay, I am going to be pulling oracles today. I already thought about you guys while I was shuffling and pulled some love oracles for those of you that are singled or troubled in love, okay, as well as some spiritual oracles, okay, that I'll go over. I'm going to pull a Lenormand, okay, for four areas of your life. Okay, if I have to post this in two uploads, which I may, just to go ahead and get part of it up because I had some electrical issues in my house and couldn't get it up yesterday. I had to have an electrician here. If, must be a Uranus thing. Anyways, if I put it in two, then the link to the other part will be listed below, okay? It'll be the first link below, all right? That said, for my Libra, can I please have in the area of work and career, please, one Lenormand. You guys have the Clover for work and career. That's excellent. I love that for you guys, okay? That is like popping. On the ones that we pulled for your spiritual cards are Covered Soul and the Restless Mind. So I do get the feeling that some of you guys have a restless mind about a few things right now. Okay, we're going to get into it, or you will, in the third week of July. I need for my Libra for love. Okay, this is long road, okay? So some of you guys have, you know, endured some sort of long road here, okay, when it comes to love, okay, and these are also popping up here. It's almost like for some of you, you're going through some endings, you know, and if you are, it may have been sudden, okay, because we have lightning here, sudden change, shocking news, surprise, epiphany, upheaval, transformation, and then the relationship's over, no second chances. And now on the family and home front, we've pulled the ring, okay, which has a lot to do with an actual ring, okay, and love, okay, the promise of love, contracts related to love, okay. So for some of you, you may be wrapping up something or have a significant relationship or foundation here that's either cracked significantly or it's forming for some of you, okay? For others of you, you may just be involved in contracts that are somehow tied into love, okay? You know, if you're leasing your first place together, that would be tied to something, you know, connected to this ring here, okay? We have the fish on the self, aisle for self, okay? That is like very, very fortuitous for you guys on the self-care aisle, okay? There may be extra money around for you guys to invest in some of your own self-care in a way that there hasn't been before, or you may be just investing more time, energy, and effort and finding, like, that, you know, whatever you're investing here on a spiritual, emotional, or physical level into your health is paying you back, like you're seeing results, okay, in this third week in July, okay. We also do have the butterfly relationship evolving, okay, inner child and growth, and new phase, rekindle, renew, transformation, change mind. So some of you guys may be reconsidering something from the past. This seems to be a theme that's been popping up lately in several of the signs, okay. You know, I do have give your relationship a chance. I have past life relationship. This could just be somebody coming back to you in a Six of Cups stance, or somebody you've changed your mind in regards to that you want to pursue a relationship with, even if you haven't had one before. Okay. And then for some, you know, we have new love, and this could be the one. So some, I'm getting two themes here, and one of them has to do with, closing out cycles and old relationships and, you know, possibly, you know, some sort of breakup here, okay? And for others of you, there may be somebody on the horizon that you have your eye on that you're interested in and that you may have known before, okay? Even if you dated them a long time ago, you know, in one way or another, okay? I'm going to pull some clarifiers on these, okay? I'm going to pull a six-pointed cross for you today to go over some of the goals for the week, okay, that you guys may be popping for you guys, all right? that said, if this doesn't resonate, please check your other placements, sun, moon, and rising, okay? And any stellums, all right? If you have a sun, moon, or rising next to the cusp of a zodiac sign, always check both signs, okay? Insofar as that's concerned, okay? For my Libra, for the third week in July, please. Goal one, please. I have here, I feel like, for some of you, this Three of Wands, okay? So some of you guys are, waiting. I think Virgo had this as well. So if you're dealing with a Virgo, or you are born by the Virgo Libra cusp, please make sure you check both Virgo and Libra, okay? Because this was one of Virgo's goals, okay? I need the hope and the fear related to this goal, okay? So some of you guys may be waiting for results again on multiple fronts, okay? On multiple fronts here, okay? I feel like for some of you, it could be in relation to a project that didn't go over well, in which case, I do see luck here if it has to do with a work project, all right, that you may be able to get some results on something, okay? You may feel like you've just lost your fire in regards to this, okay? Or you're just becoming a little bit defensive or there's guards up in relation to this, okay? Others of you are, you're waiting, for some sort of return on some work that you've done. It could be romantically or career wise. Okay, I'm going to get into it with the clarifiers here when I take a look at the whole spread. Okay, give me from my Libra for the third week in July, goal two. High Priestess is at the bottom of the deck on this one. Maybe dealing with somebody with significant Pisces placements. The Lovers just came out in reverse on this. Some of you may feel like you have made the wrong choice and didn't follow your intuition on something, okay? We'll see what that's about, Libra, all right? That may be coming to the fore of your mind or as a part of activity here, all right? Gemini energy with the Lovers card. Please give me the hope. And the fear. Please give me the overall choice that Libra has. All right, Ten of Pentacles is at the bottom on your overall choice, and your overall choice seems to be related to the King of Pentacles. Okay, there is some sort of leap here that may be coming up for some of you guys that you feel like you need to take, and some of you guys may be experiencing either some business or like just fears of poverty or lack mindset. Okay, it could be affecting your family right now. Others of you may be in a decision period over whether to engage with a King of Pentacles, masculine energy behind the card, but could be a Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus. If you have those placements in your own chart, take a look at them and the aspects forming to them right now, because you may be undergoing a space and time where the King of Pentacles here is showing up in reverse, okay? So you may have some sort of instance where you're feeling in a reversed King of Pentacles like stance, okay? And a King of Pentacles in reverse could be facing financial loss or hardships, okay? Or fears, okay? You can also engage in like some shoddy dealings, okay? Or be overly materialistic or possessive of his money and abusive of it in one way or another, okay? Could be in business, could be as a father, could be on several fronts, okay? This may be a person in your energy that you need to make a choice to step away from or not have dealings with. Or it could be reflective of another piece of you that's going on right now in fears or just things that are, occurring for you guys, okay? What I have here, you know, is the choice, is to not engage with this person, okay? To meet the goals that you have, you need to not engage with this person or turn around your perspective in one way or another, okay, in relation to this reverse King of Pentacles stance here, okay? If this is not related to another person, it's just, you know, re-examining these things in yourself here, Libra, okay, and how you may be in a reverse King of Pentacles stance, okay? You may feel demasculated in some manner or another, okay, in regards to a business or in regards to fatherhood in one way or another having to do with money, okay, or something of this sort, but we'll see here, okay? Some of you... You know, some of you, and with some of you, this may play out in a partnership scenario, okay? Because I do have here that one of the goals is the Lovers is here, and the Lovers is appearing in reverse, okay? So sometimes that means that you feel like you've lost a chance with somebody that you really want or made a bad decision in love or are facing indecision on an important matter, okay? Where you can't make a choice, because the Lovers does have to do with a choice. It's about grabbing hold to the positive choice and either a significant soulmate connection or love connection, you know, and sometimes that revolves around choices, the choice to love. Okay, you guys, some of you guys may be having a hard time with the choice to love, or to love healthily here, or feel like you made a bad decision. Okay, I feel like communication may be blocked in some way or another in regards to what this matter is. I will be pulling clarifiers, but the Seven of Cups came out in reverse, and so did the Page of Swords, okay, related to this goal, okay, that's going to be coming up or on your mind the third week of July. So I feel like communication or news is halted on some front related to this Lover's card here, okay, and you feel like your options have closed or are dwindling here. Seven of Cups in reverse. Okay, and when I see that the options are dwindling, and then I see the Lovers in reverse with it, okay, it could have to do with something significant with work, but we'll see here, okay? Then on the second goal I do see that you guys have invested some amount of business or commerce or work of a significant project into something, and you're waiting for the results to come back in, okay? With the Three of Wands as a goal here, you know, you may feel a lot of anticipation waiting for things to come back in. This could have to do with contracts of some kind or other just work that you're working on with somebody else, but it definitely implies that you've put in effort or you're putting in effort somewhere, okay? But I do see on this that hope is the Knight of Wands in reverse, okay? This can speak of not losing, like not acting, not being overly arrogant, okay, in regards to your expectations, okay, because you're waiting for those ships to come back in and returns to come back in of some sort in some area of your life. So not wanting to be over arrogant maybe at play here, and then also a desire not to be, now if it relates to love, it could be like not being player-like, okay? And that's in you or somebody else. It could be with somebody else, you know, if you've been, you know, involved with a player or something like that, it could be hoping that this person, you know, gets out of their player ways, all right? But if it's revolved around business or in revolved around you here, with this Three of Wands, I see it related to more than likely something to do with with you wanting to not give up, okay? Because the Knight of Wands is a great spearheader. He's great, you know, he has a lot of drive and fire behind what he's doing and work, okay? But if you're not seeing the results, if you're not getting the raises that you feel you deserve for the amount of efforts that you put in, or the bonuses or something of this sort, okay, you could feel your fire is dying out here in one sort or another. But with the Clover being here, okay, I think that you are going to get favorable returns, okay? Your fear here in regards to this goal for the third week of July is showing up as the Seven of Wands, okay, and the upright. So for me, this is saying that you do hope that you can, like, ward off either negative behavior in others or yourself and remain on higher ground here, okay, and in control here of this, of whatever it is you're waiting for here, all right? So sometimes this could imply that you feel attacked a little bit okay? You know, or have a need to defend yourself, okay? If other people are attacking you in some regard here, Libra, okay? But let's pull some clarifiers and delve further into this, okay? I do see, like, you also pulled this under my umbrella and treasured memories. So I do feel like there's somebody around you that you very much treasure that may, you may be having some feelings of nostalgia and memories around, you know, of one sort or another in the third week of July. And I do feel like either you or somebody else may need a little protection from the rain, a little bit of support in one way or another, emotional, you know, support of one way or another, okay, with this under my umbrella or, you know, oracle card here, okay? But I am going to pull on this lightning here real quick, okay, to see. Let me just make sure my deck is, yeah. Can I get the lightning, please? Queen of Pentacles. I want another one. Four of Wands. Oh, shit. And the Nine of Swords. Some of you guys may have news coming in, okay? Because now I have a King and a Queen of Pentacles, okay? So sometimes that's my symbol for a domesticated partnership, and there may be something that strikes like lightning in the third week of July for some of you. Hang on. Give me this Grim Reaper. Regarding a past or present relationship, okay, which was unexpected news or something of this sort that really just shakes you up, all right, Libra, yeah, okay, for some of you, this is going to play out next week, okay, so take heed here. There is a reverse King of Pentacles, and, you know, you may feel in this reverse stance, okay, the third week of July because of something that happens, okay, because I have sudden change, shocking news, surprise, epiphany, upheaval, and transformation. And I got the Queen of Pentacles, the Four of Wands, and the Nine of Swords. So I do see a lot of anxiety here and possibly argumentation or fights with your domesticated partner or significant other or spouse here. Okay? Alternatively, it could be coming from an ex that you had a significant foundation with or a mother figure. Could be for some of you. All right, but on this like change with the Grim Reaper falling right after this one, I got the Ten of Wands, the Knight of Wands, and the Tower. Okay, and the Knight of Wands I told you is in reversed over here. So it could just be that like there's this huge thing that shakes you up that just like blows out your fire. Like if somebody cheated on you, for instance, and you find out about it or something of this sort, it might, you know, kill your, just freaking really shake you up here, okay? The Moon, I wasn't asking for anything, and the Moon and the High Priestess fell out, okay? That is like a lot of secrets, okay, Libra? And the Ace of Pentacles and the Moon just tried to pop out again, okay? Some of these may be related to something significant that also shakes you up financially, which is why the King of Pentacles is in reverse here. For some of you, it may, okay? Hang on a second, Libra. Let me just pull on this. There's something that happens, and then there's something that's just really shocking, okay? That, you know, if it's not about you, it could be about somebody significant in your family or your parents, okay? If you find out that your parents are getting divorced all of a sudden and you're long grown and grown out of the house, it could have to do with your parents. Could. For some of you, okay, hold on. Give me this ring over here. On the ring, I get the Ace of Rods, the Page of Swords, and the Tower, okay? So for some of you, there may be some infidelity issues that come up next week, either in you or your partner or with your parents or somebody else significant in your family, okay, that shake you to your core, okay? The World just popped out with that, okay? That brings some sort of ending and tower here into your life here, Libra, okay? I'm really sorry for those of you that experience this next week, okay? But there's like three different cards here pointing to it now, and so are the clarifiers, okay? At the same time, I don't see you like totally bent out of shape here, but there may have been some news that you were waiting on that's delayed here. Hold on. Give me the Lovers down here. On the lovers, I do feel like this is somewhat related to feeling really tied up on a front that may involve love, okay? I get the eight of, on the lovers in reverse, I get the eight of swords, the sun in reverse, and the four of cups. Okay, so there's some sort of thing that's on your mind next week that hits you kind of hard. It may be an argument, it may be a fight, it may have to do with your parents or somebody else in your family, okay? But there's some shakeup, and it may have to do with a partnership of some sort or another, whether that's yours or somebody very close to you, okay? Here, Libra, all right? And there's some sort of decision that was made that you feel all tied up and in knots about next week, all right? Or this week, rather, sorry, that... leaves you feeling like a lack of joy and discontentment here. You feel like you didn't take an offer that you should have, or you lost out on something. I've already gone over that. Okay. This could have to do with somebody you had children with. Okay. If you have Virgo, the Hermit is popping up here again. All right. The Seven of Cups in reverse. I get the Empress, the Six of Rods in reverse, and the Hermit. Okay. If you're on the cusp, this could be you. Okay. But there's some sort of like lack of options here, which leaves you feeling like you're at a loss, or like that you lost, that you didn't get a victory, and you're either not talking about it, or you're going to go into seclusion about it, or there's some sort of intuition or secrets and higher like, hold on, what's this Page of Swords? Here it is again. I hear it goes again. On this Page of Swords, I get the Ace of Cups, okay, the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, and the Queen of Pentacles. So for some of you, I feel like you may find out that somebody's taken that you wanted, okay? This person may be, you know, an Empress in your eyes, okay? Or you may feel that person, somebody may, you know, something happens here, okay, with this person, and news is delayed, and action was delayed as well, whether on your part or the part of somebody else, okay? There's an Ace of Cups here. There was a lot of love here, okay? But this Knight of Pentacles is in reverse, which means there's no movement forward, okay? And then the Queen of Pentacles. So there's no movement and there's no news, or news and action was delayed. Okay, and for that reason, it left you feeling like you couldn't make a decision, or you made the wrong decision. Six of Cups, this could be an old soul tie, or somebody you feel a soul tie with. Okay, take it as it resonates. Okay, give me this Knight of Wands in reverse. Five of Cups. I'm gonna do a thing later this week on Venus, okay, your ruling sign moving into Cancer, all right, and I'll do a spread for every single sign, okay? This Knight of Wands in reverse, I get the Five of Cups, the Nine of Swords, and the Two of Rods. I do feel like there's somebody else here that you're talking to here that you know, or somebody else is, all right, dealing with an offer, all right, that maybe was or was not taken, or something else here that was done that you feel foolish about, or somebody else does, okay, that there's a lot of anxiety about and a lot of mental stress about here with this Nine of Swords here, okay? It has to do with a choice and an opportunity here with this Two of Rods, okay? But there's a Five of Cups and a Nine of Swords with it. I feel like the opportunity wasn't taken, or it was lost, or you feel like it was here. Libra, give me this Seven of Wands. On this Seven of Wands, okay, I see here a fear, okay, related to this Seven of Wands, that if you leave, okay, or somebody else does, okay, Six of Swords, Ten of Pentacles, Page of Pentacles, that if you leave, you're going to be attacked, or you need to block yourself from attack, related to a move towards greater stability here for you, okay, all right, having to do with family and legacy, inheritance, and wealth here, all right, and possibly a family scenario here that you feel like you're going to need to defend yourself, okay, about a move that you may make or be contemplating here with the Six of Swords, Ten of Pentacles, and the Page of Pentacles here. Maybe worried about a split of assets and worried about losing assets, okay, if you are going through a significant breakup or divorce with a live-in. Okay, Give me this Three of Wands here. Oh my God. On the Three of Wands, I have the Star, the Three of Pentacles, and Justice. Okay, so there is like, you are waiting for significant healing regarding a significant collaboration and a sense of justice to be brought to a situation here. Okay, all right. Okay, Four of Pentacles is just in reverse. Okay, if you have Aquarius in your chart, you're showing up here. Okay, Aquarius, the Star just showed up, the Three of Pentacles and Justice, all right? This is pretty heavy, Libra. I've had a couple reads here for these weeklies for next week that have gotten rather heavy and lengthier, but that's been the nature of the game this month. Okay, let me pull a different deck to clarify this. Let me pull a different deck to clarify this King of Pentacles in reverse here, Libra, for you. Some reason you felt like you took an option, okay, and you may have children with multiple people. Some of you may. King of Pentacles. I have the Wheel of Fortune, all right, the Eight of Swords, and the Ten of Cups. So some of you feel like, again, that you've missed some sort of timing issue here, or there's some timing issue where you feel cut off and entrapped within your own body here, possibly, Libra, in the third week of July, where you feel like this Ten of Cups is eluding you, okay? This sense of home and happiness around family that you dream of and want to create is eluding you, and you're tied off from it, and it has to do with timing and you missing timing here. For some of you, this is just, it's just all over this read. I keep looking for something else, you know, and it could play out. You know, it could play out for some of you that do not have children, that have never lived with anyone else and are single. This could be in regards to your parents. Okay. All right. Other significant mother and father figure in your life that leave you feeling at a loss here. Okay. Give me this long road here. Okay. With this long road here in love, though, I feel like for a lot of you, it's going to have to do with your relationship on this, your love life on this, long road. I have the Mother of Cups. Okay. So this is like a long road in one or more relationships in your life here, Libra. Okay. Where you've been through multiple battles here. Okay. And it's showing up the Daughter of Swords. Okay. Could be representative of a child, especially if they are an air sign. Okay. Alternatively, it could be representative of news and action taking place here in regards to a change that comes up or is being contemplated the third week of July, okay, which requires a lot of communication and action on your part. Why is the Sun of Swords here? Hold on. The Hangman and the Mother of Pentacles. Whatever is action is being taken, again, you may feel like you're in a state of waiting here or really trying to, the Hangman is like in the reverse here though. Yeah, the Hangman's in the reverse. So when this King of Swords comes in, I mean, not the King of Swords, this Knight of Swords, okay, this communication and swift action, okay, which does not always bring good news, okay, and it may be related to a Mother of Pentacles, somebody with Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus in their chart, okay. Or this is you. You've popped around the whole damn thing here. But so is the King of Pentacles, specifically. All right? When this news comes in, and again, I'm going to go back to this. This is related to a domestic partnership. And since I do see this popping on your long road, I don't know. I feel like this is tied into your life, okay? And your family life as well, okay? All right. That this So I do feel like for some of you, this is somebody you lived with or somebody you live with currently. That when this news or action takes place, okay, that any waiting around that was previously, communication and action move forward here, okay? All right? But they may have been delayed for quite some time, because I can see the fears here related to communication and delays over here, okay? But I also see this being tied up to love and not just a wrap-up here, okay? And some sort of missed opportunity here, or and crying over spilt milk, what's already gone in some way or another here, Libra, going on. What is the fish here? Libra. Whoever resonates with this, please drop me a line, because this is a really heavy one, and so I would really like to know. This just keeps showing up. This is what's really crazy, but good. Okay, here on the self, okay, internally, whatever happened is happening here on an external basis is quite apparent. Internally, I have on this fish, which is very prosperous, okay, and to me says that, you know, it's a very fortuitous on an internal, spiritual, emotional, and physical level for the Isle of Self. I have the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, the Tower, and the Five of Swords. So, whatever Tower moment that occurs, and if there is a family break, it's like if there is a break, it is a release that winds up being good for you internally. Okay, that's what the cards are showing here. Okay, hold on. Why is the Tower here? I feel like I need another deck. Okay, when I see you like cut off from your happiness here and restricted and in this reverse stance, like definitely changes need to happen. But for some reason, there's something about this that's like happens unexpectedly or unexpected news, delayed news, something here. Okay, what is this Tower? So you may be causing a Tower. On the Tower, I get the Eight of Wands, the King of Cups, and the Four of Wands. For some of you, you may be causing the Tower. You may be bringing down this Tower. Because I had the Queen of Cups over here on this long road. There may be multiple individuals involved here, okay? But here on this Tower, I get the Eight of Wands, the King of Cups, and the Four of Wands. There's something that greatly shakes some sort of marriage or significant relationship here going on. And if it's not with you, it's with your family. And it creates like an uproar, like nobody expects it. Okay, so the news is rather jarring. But for a lot of you, I think this is you. What is this Five of Swords? And it could be that some cattiness or jealousy or some bad shit that somebody does gets found out next week. Four of Cups. Page of Cups. And the Star. Stars. Again, with the Aquarian energy. And it's like there is a lot of discontent here over if you've been fighting within your significant relationship for a long time. And there's been really shitty, shoddy behavior, some of which you find out about, okay? Or something really freaking crazy here. It kind of breaks next week or this week, all right? Here with the Four of Cups, a feeling of discontent around a lot of argumentation. Five of Swords is like really like all out brawls with someone, okay? And then I have that with the Page of Cups and the Star. So it's like there's some sort of discontent because like what you dream of as to this Ten of Cups and a significant relationship, whatever this relationship is here that breaks, or for those of you that resonates with, it's anything but like this, okay? It's anything but whatever is like you know, this like sweet love of, you know, involved with a Page of Cups and the Star. Okay. That is a lot of healing and like just emotional fulfillment and, you know, just admiration. It's like there's no admiration for this person where this Five of Swords is. Okay, for others of you, it could have to do with somebody going outside the relationship and some sort of realization of that, okay? But for a lot of you, I feel like you are emotionally spent on the inside here in one way or another because of something that occurs here, and I already told you, has to do with movement and communication, okay? King of Cups is your emotions, okay? Deep well of emotions regarding what? Significant foundation, Four of Wands. What is it? Why is the Ten of Pentacles here? But what like makes me think that for some of you, the Queen of Pentacles again. Why is the Ten of Pentacles in reverse here? The Empress. This is somebody that you guys have children with for some of you. Okay. Ten of Pentacles being in reverse. It's like something, and the Nine of Swords. A lot of anxiety and worry. Okay. Sleepless nights over this potential person, or you are this person, okay? Because I do have the Queen of Pentacles, so for some of you, you are this Queen of Pentacles here with the Empress, okay? For others of you, this is your mate here, okay? Virgo, Capricorn, Taurinian energy, all right? Especially if you have that in your chart, this is you here with the Empress, okay? And you're in a lot of anxiety, or you used to be, okay, about a Ten of Pentacles with this person. You literally may be the one, due to your own love for yourself and self-care, which is something's going out the window here on, that this tower is maybe brought by you. Something just boils over and breaks, okay? For those of you that this resonates with, please let me know. For others of you, I see this as occurring in regards to your... if you've never had any children or lived with anyone, because I do see this as a significant love relationship foundation here, then you may get news of a breakup within the family that rocks everybody's world here, okay? All right, let me know how it goes, Libra, okay? All right, because the choice you have here in regards to this King of Pentacles in reverse, which is your choice. You can act like the King of Pentacles in reverse, or you can turn yourself back in the upright, okay? Has to do with the Wheel of Fortune, okay? The Eight of Swords, okay? That's a mental imprisonment, okay, of your own mind, or somebody else imprisoning you, all right? And what are they imprisoning you off from? Your Ten of Cups, your emotional fulfillment and happiness at home. Timing. When we don't make a move on our own, what does the universe bring us? A tower. The timing may be occurring this week for that tower. For some of you it is. I could read this a bunch of different ways. I'm trying to, but I just can't on this one. Except to say that it may be your parents. It's just all over it, and like I haven't got, there's no accident that I keep getting the Empress and the Queen of Pentacles, that I keep getting I've only gotten the King and Queen of Cups, you know, as it relates to this relationship, okay? Also significant of the two partners, you know, that are at play here, okay? I haven't got a King of Swords once. I haven't got a Queen of Swords once, okay? Or a King or Queen of Wands. This is about a specific couple, very specific couple. Okay, it may be related to a marriage or a significant partner that you live with, okay, or used to live with, okay? Okay, so, but you feel, what's the most important part here and identifying here is that the choice has to do with this King of Pentacles in reverse, okay? And for those of you that are leaving this person, you know, you might be leaving this person. For others of you, you are this King of Pentacles in reverse. But there is a King and Queen of Pentacles that are experiencing a tower moment and a possible breakup or shakeup in the foundation. And the Libra that's showing up here shows, whichever you are, shows that it's a matter of like self-care, self-love, self-whatever. Like some of you are in a toxic relationship with a controlling person that you're just miserable in, that there's a lot of fights with all the time. And there may also be some news that you get that really shakes you up, okay, in regards to something this person has done or hidden from you, for some of you, or something you've done, Libra, that creates some sort of, okay, but the advice, which I already told you in the King of Pentacles, was to take, you know, the universe provides the timing. When we don't move on things that need to die away, structures that are unsound or not for us, the Tower comes. And the Tower is here several times in this reading, okay? And then it's related to home and family. I've gotten Ten of Cups upright or in reverse several times, as well as the Four of Wands, all right? As well as the Empress, which is you, okay? Virgo also showed up here, as did Aquarius, okay? But again, I feel like this relates to somebody you are directly involved with now, okay? Or your parents or somebody else significant in your family, okay? All right, and it, you know, so the divine timing and the wheel spinning, that's on offer from spirit, because the wheel is fun. But to get yourself out of this reverse stance, if this is you, it's take time of the divine timing to free yourself from your own, free yourself from whatever's cutting you off from your emotional happiness. Okay. All right. Let me know how it goes, Libra. I love you guys. And I am going to clean this up and I'm going to move to Scorpio. Libra. I forgot to read your soul card. You got covered soul. It says a fire is covered by smoke as a mirror is covered by dust, or as the embryo is covered by the womb. Similarly, the living being is covered by different layers of lust. Okay, so again, I feel like some of you have issues of infidelity that are going to come to the surface, or desires for infidelity of some sort that are realized, that for some reason drive you to break a relationship because you realize that you wouldn't be doing that unless you were unhappy and the relationship can't be mended, or something of this sort. Okay, the yoga practitioner whose mind is unbridled can never attain self-realization. Only one who has mastered the self and who strives by right means is assured of success. And I did see that there for you on that self aisle. It's like there's this big real, you know, for whatever reason on that self aisle, I feel like whatever happens, it's like the best for you internally. Okay, for whoever was resonating with this, I can't believe it's like every single one of these cards is going to it, you know? Anyway, Libra, I'm sorry for those of you that this one resonates with. If it did not resonate for you, just make sure you check your other placements, okay? But whatever you're talking with, like some Libra here is definitely all over every damn oracle here that I read on this, okay? Let me know how it goes, Libra. Okay? I'll be thinking of you guys. Hi, Scorpio. I'm here to do your weekly readings. Okay? I had some power issues yesterday, so I could not get it up yesterday as planned. But everything was fixed this morning, so I'm at it. You got two, so I'll keep two. You may have pulled three on me here. Okay? I will be pulling oracles. I will be pulling a six-pointed star. Okay? All right, in which I will identify some goals and hopes and fears around those goals. All right, we have God's reciprocation, material elements, and determination. Okay, so I do feel like there's some stuff with finances going on here, as well as like positive manifestation and tapping in here, okay, to something that you really, really want here, okay, with for you here on this front. Okay, but I'm going to wait a minute to read these because I am going to also pull oracles for love. All right, for those of you that are singled or troubled in love, I will pull oracles on that as well. Hold on 1 second, Scorpio. For those of you that are on the Libra-Scorpio cusp of your Sun, Moon, Rising, or Stellium, whichever you're in here checking for, North Node, etc., always check your Sun, Moon, and Rising though, okay? But if you are on the cusp, definitely check Libra's reading because they just had a hell of a read. And it seems to be going on just in general right now with the reads this month are just really heavy. They've been running a lot longer because they are heavy, and I don't want to leave anybody hanging when they're a heavy read. I just don't like to do that. So We have worth the wait on the bottom, okay? And finances and career, again, there's something here going on with material things on the front. I'm going to pull some Lenormands, one for your career, okay? I'll also pull for love, home, and family, as well as for self, okay? And then I will pull that spread. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Definitely like it. Helps the channel grow. It's very important. Let's see, healthy choices, sunglasses, okay, abundance, axe, two more. I feel like some people are like going through like breakups and like redos and whatnots, and I have like, it's so funny how these two like categories popped out together like in two separate spots. So I feel like you also, those of you that are single, maybe going through some sort of breakup, okay, and changing a lot on an internal level, okay, trying to drive your own abundance here and make healthy choices on a love front, okay, and you may have some old karmic here still hanging around, or somebody you're giving the axe to here, Scorp. For those of you that are singled or troubled in love, okay? I've already posted some of the love reads for the month, and I will be posting the rest. Your 7-7 sign Taurus is up if you're dealing with a Taurus, okay? I need my position one. I'm going to pull your Lenormands first. Okay, I need a Lenormand for my Scorpio for the third week of July. I will post for the new moon, and then I'm also going to make a post for with a spread for every sign for Venus's move through Cancer, okay, because it's at the tail end of Gemini now, and I will post for every single sign and do a little astrology talk, okay, with a house-by-house analysis for each one of you guys, okay? I'll post that towards the end of the week when I get done with more of my of the rest of the love reads, all right, for singled and troubled. They've been really heavy. My Scorpio. We have the mice. The mice has appeared in like four different readings, okay? You are the only person to have gotten it on the career front, career and work front, okay? Everybody else's was either on the love front or on the family and home front, okay? The mice can indicate a lot of chitter chatter and gossip. It can also indicate like somebody, you know, issues at work. Okay, now you're pulling the snake on the love front. So there's either a big transformation going on here, or you've been dealing with a snake, Scorpio. What are you going to do to me today, Scorp? Okay, everybody else is giving me a hard time today. All right, not a hard time for me, just a hard time for them. And I'm not going to leave them hanging. So let's see what you got. This could just be transformation on a love front. Big transformation, okay? The snake is big transformation. If it's transformation, it is really big transformation, okay? On the home and family front, you have the bouquet, all right? So there may be something good coming in or something around. A lot of, like, love and pleasantry and some romance here on the home and family front. A lot of happiness here, okay? Or good times, all right? On offer, okay? On a self front, you have the key, okay? This is definitely a great card to pull on the self front, okay? It's like indicative that you are or you are trying to tap into a higher purpose to get some answers with your intuition and in so far as self-care, really tapping into some changes you wanna make, possibly insofar as self is concerned, whether on a physical, emotional, or spiritual basis here, okay? And it does indicate really tapping into some intuition for some key understanding here on what needs to happen for your own self-care, okay? Because this does have ties to the High Priestess as well as the Hierophant here, okay? So there are some answers on offer here for you. If you tap into your intuition, you know, you'll know the answers of what needs to be ramped up or taken care of here on a self-care front in the third week of July. For my Scorpio, can I have position one of the first goal? We have justice at the bottom. Again, if you're dealing with a Libra or you're on the Libra cusp, okay, I have a goal of a five of swords. I don't really like seeing that. Okay, we'll see why it's there. But I don't like seeing a five of swords as a goal. But, you know, as a goal, it can mean I'm going to have somebody by any means or a thing. Okay. All right. But it can also be defeat. Okay. And knowing when to walk away from certain things and not engage in battle. Okay. Here. I see a hope surrounding, I like this. I see a hope surrounding this five of swords as a goal. So I do think that you want to walk away from any bad behavior, bickering, arguing, etc. Especially that is like, you know, unfair arguments, unfair fighting, kind of like pyrrhic victory kind of feeling. You know, there are no real winners here. Even if you win, you know, an unfair, you know, behavior or arguments. The goal here is the star. So I see you wanting to walk away from that if that's going on around you, okay? There is a fear surrounding movement or communication out here. Eight of Wands. Okay, can I have goal two for my Scorpio, please? When Venus goes through the sign, Ace of Cups, okay? Overflowing love and creativity at the bottom. Divine Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups, okay, this could be you or another person around you or just be significant of a relationship card. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio indicated by the card, okay, does not have to be though. Again, it does serve as a relationship card, okay, or a love card of some sort, okay. Can I have the hopes and the fears surrounding this? Fear. Choice related to these goals for my Scorpio for the third week in July. I'm going to call these out as soon as I'm done. You're going to go with me again, okay? The sun is at the bottom of the deck. Six of Wands, a victory behind that. And in the position, which is your choice, Scorp, okay, is a Six of Swords. Moving to calmer waters. Sometimes an actual move away. Sometimes a breakup. Sometimes a breakup with a move. Sometimes it's just moving to calmer waters to restabilize your life on a certain area where there's been issues or problems, okay? Or Five of Swords-like behavior, okay? So what I see here is the other goal that I saw with this Queen of Cups. I have a hope out of a Two of Wands with that. Okay, so you hope that you can make some offers or make some choices or have open a door to some new opportunities here. Okay, may or may not be related to love. Okay, and then you have a fear around a Knight of Swords. Taking some action that maybe you need to take to deliver some news which may be harsh. Or having someone take action or receiving news from someone else that may be harsh. Or hasty, okay? Not wanting to make any hasty moves, okay? There could be a fear around making the wrong move or communicating or acting in the wrong manner here that's occurring for some of you guys on some front, okay? I want to pull a couple on this mice to start. I do feel like some of you that are single may be going through some sort of breakup, and you may still have your eye on your ex, or your ex has their eye on you. Okay, and you know, you may be involved with somebody who is, you know, gaslighting you a bit. Hopefully that's not you, Scorpio. You know if that's you, okay? But I do see, you know, an end to that is near with the axe and ascending. Okay, and then I do see like healthy choices, abundance, and paradise, okay? I do have pay attention to red flags here. Again, I have financial issues may be a factor in your love life right now. I see that with the snake and the mice showing up here. You know, could be, you know, financial issues in general can affect our love lives as well, especially when we're in a significant partnership, okay? But I do see stay optimistic, you know, at the same time it says pay attention to red flags. The signs are cautioning you. So I do feel like there's some signs here cautioning you here. I want to pull on the snake first. Let's do that first. Can I have the snake here? All right, Scorpio, you're showing up here on the snake. Okay, some of you that are in a relationship or involved in things of a relationship, okay, that need to end or close here, they need to transform. You need to shed your skin on like a snake, okay, or involved with a person who was a snake with you or is acting snake-like or something deceptive here going on in a love front. I do see an Eight of Cups in the reverse, death in the upright, and the Six of Pentacles. Okay, I see like a languishing of not walking away from something maybe here going on that you need to walk away from that's very emotional here, affecting your love life, all right? There needs to be a transformation in regards to it, okay? Death card, your card, Scorpionic energy, okay? And it indicated here that it relates to the give and take in a relationship or something that's coming up with a give and take, and it may have to do with money. Six of Pentacles is here. Okay, I'm gonna delve further. Give me the, you're like popping with strength in the Nine of Pentacles, okay? There may be a lack of a feeling of independence or fears around independence here, either in you or your partner going on here. What is this, why are the mice here on the career and work front? Why are the mice here for my Scorpio for the third week of July? Justice. There's some imbalance at work. King of Rods could be related to a fire sign. Does not have to be. You could be showing up with this energy, especially if you have a placement in here you're checking for by the Sag cusp, could be, or you have another significant placement here. But this King of Rods is looking to justice. I'll ask you for a second, Scorp. Somebody has dipped into the coffers more than they should here. Okay, and that there's some sort of injustice surrounding your career or work, okay, may be related to a boss-like figure, a King of Wands with heavy fire in their chart, or this could be you, okay, but for some reason I'm feeling like, you know, there's something going on in the cupboards here with the mice here, okay, they that's what it tends to have to do with. Okay, with the Lenormand card, and I feel like this figure here, this king-like figure here, whether it's you or somebody else here, Scorpio, is looking at justice as if what's going on is just, okay? I don't know if that's you or not yet. Hold on. I'm getting a feeling if you're, for some reason, it's either a partnership or something else here, okay? That you feel as might feel as unjust. Why is justice here? King of Pentacles in reverse. Temperance. And the Ace of Wands. Again, if you have Scorpio Sag placements or by the cusp, and that's why you're in here, make sure you check Sag too, okay? But there is a King of Pentacles and some Sag here representative with Temperance, okay, that somebody here is being materialistic with the King of Pentacles here. Again, this looks like some sort of boss-like figure, partner, or head-like figure here at work, okay? With Temperance and the Ace of Wands is here for a new beginning, okay? There's some sort of greed or something going on here, and you may feel like you are not Nine of Swords, that you're in a lot of heavy anxiety over here, Scorpio, okay, about what's gone on here on a work front, okay, for the third week in July here, okay? We're gonna pull some more here, okay? This may tie down to this Five of Swords down here, okay? You may be afraid to make a move or communicate about this issue or heal it because of what's gone on, okay? Give me this bouquet on the family front. On the home and family front, we get a card that shows up here in the heart of your read. We have the Queen of Swords, the Six of Swords, and the Knight of Cups. There may be somebody who's very sharp at work, Or, this is home and family, okay? There may be some cuts you need to make, all right, to move yourself to this romantic bouquet-like atmosphere, or you feel to maintain this bouquet-like atmosphere. It's like there's like a going away of... There may be some cuts of some sort or another here. Hold on, this is kind of crazy here. And Eight of Swords is popping out. There's some restrictions around romance at home and on a family front here, or some interference with happy family ties and romance in the home due to some sharp-like behavior that could be emanating from a feminine figure that's acting as a Queen of Swords. Okay, that's not very warm and cuddly, okay? This Queen of Swords has been very hot in a lot of the readings right now, okay, for some behaviors that have been going, if it just keep coming up, or air sign energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarian energy. Who is this Queen of Swords? What? No. I'm going to have to go back to that one because I want to see something else before I speak on it, okay? It's like heavy. Oh, guys, give me a heavy read. Did I expect anything else with a Scorpio? I mean, you didn't come in here for light. Right? All right. What is this key here? Yeah. Ace of Pentacles. I do see some investment here on your self-care that you're really honing into your intuition on how do I care for myself better. You're like ready to make a financial investment in that. Okay. Ace of Pentacles, or you may have more free time to engage in some self-care. All right, or you may want to communicate or take action on this, okay, rather swiftly, but you feel like it's being blockaded in one way or another. For some of you, it could be, or you're trying to blockade out, like, disturbing communications and tension or movements going on with other parts of your life here on this self aisle to reassess, okay, what needs to be done. You may have gotten some advice, could be, from a doctor or something of this sort lately, or something about your health, physically, emotionally, or spiritually has been kind of crying out to you on some action that you need to take swiftly, okay, to guard yourself here and reinvest in yourself here on a self aisle here. And like the Lenormand is indicating that the key to this is going to be tapping into your intuition and following your intuition on what you need to do for love of yourself, self-care, you know, taking care of your soul and your physical body and your emotional state here, that you may want to invest in it some here. Okay. This Knight of Swords appears down here as well. And like what I'm seeing here is, again, I said that there is some sort of fear. There could be a fear around acting or communicating, especially if the message is not great or what you want to do, you don't feel like is going to upset the alignment of a personal relationship here. This fear could be spilling out onto your self-care aisle and your image and feelings about yourself right now in a way that like you feel blockaded off from and reinvesting into yourself in the ways that you feel like you need to, or somehow this fear around this communication and actions are blockading, like, or you're trying to block that out when you're engaged in self-care, one or the other here. Scorpio, I do see a tie, especially since this is related to one of your fears. Hold on. Why is the Knight of Swords here? We get the, when I asked why the Knight of Swords was here on this self-care aisle, okay, which is like the Knight of Swords appeared, it's like there's a blockade of some sort with this Ace of Pentacles and this Seven of Wands. And I said it could be a person or something that's kind of interfering with, or you're trying to block out you, because you're feeling the need to tap in here and reinvest in self-care here, or like something with your mental, emotional, or physical state is being affected here. And I asked why the Knight of Swords was here, and I got the Hierophant, the Moon, and the Lovers. So there's something here that could be on a relationship level or back to this work thing, that's really secretive or regarding some choices which are secretive or but very emotional for you for some reason that are affecting you here. Okay, and for some reason you want to talk about these things, but talking about them is stressing you out because it's listed. This Knight of Swords also appears in the fear. Okay, this Hierophant could revolve around a commitment, or it could revolve around a hierarchy at work, or bureaucracy of one sort or another that you're engaged in. Okay, it could also revolve around a Taurus and a Cancer, and some choices that need to be made, or action that needs to be done here with this Knight of Swords and the Lovers here. Involving a choice could involve a Taurus and a Cancer. Does not have to. Okay, the other way that I see it applying here is, or a Gemini. Okay, is there some sort of action here that's you feel? This is like, these are three major arcanas together. Okay, this Moon could also be Pisces, but on this Knight of Swords, it's like you are being divinely called to pay attention to your self-care here now, Hierophant. It's like, do this now. Something calling out to you. But yet there's a blockade on that message or the fast receipt of that action here or some fears surrounding your engaging in it. Possibly. Okay? And I have, again, like I told you, I have the Hierophant, the Moon, and the Lovers here. Okay? So, you know, it could just be about making a choice about some things that you feel secretive about or like your emotional state here. That you need to make an investment in your self-care here to recognize that part of your self-care also has to do with managing your emotions as well. Okay, especially if your emotions or like you've been had disturbed dreams or sleep or something like this lately that's really bothering your mind right now. Okay, to take care of yourself emotionally here, to make the choice and decision to do that. You're being called to do that and to take swift action and communicate about that in one manner or another. Okay, or they're trying to tap into you to tell you you have the key to do this and understand what's going on. Pay attention to these inklings that you're getting on this vibe here. Okay, that's what I'm getting here for you, Scorpio. Hold on, I'm going to pull a different deck. Okay, and it could relate back to this Five of Swords because this can make you, you know, you can't live in a Five of Swords mindset here for very long without it seriously starting to take a toll on your chemical, hormonal balance and all of this kind of thing because you're kind of in a fight mode or a defeat mode when you're in this Five of Swords. It's like fight or flight all the time. Okay? Fight or flight. Win or lose. You know? Everything. You know? All the time. And this is like one of those battle situations that's like a shit battle. You know, there's something dirty about it feeling. You know? So that can affect your emotional state after a while, okay? Because of the vibes involved with it, okay? Give me this Five of Swords. Yeah, this is ending. You're trying to shut this down. And oh my God, on this Five of Swords, which I just said may go back to this, I pulled the Moon and the Hierophant in reverse. There's something here off about the hierarchy. This may go back to this work thing for some of you that's like leaking out into other areas of your life now that you're very emotional about, okay? And you want to shut down, one of your goals is to shut down this Five of Swords thing. So you're either going to like be like, okay, you won and walk away and not engage in it again, okay? Or you're thinking about, you know, there's some form of hierarchy here. Could be also related to other areas of your life, okay, where somebody's exerting improper control or you feel like they're not ruling properly or something of this sort, okay? Others of you could be having significant arguments within a marriage, okay, of some sort or another that are very emotional and you want to close out that cycle of doing that and take it to another level, okay, especially if this involves your home and family with this bouquet here and the snake. Okay. Hold on 1 second, Scorpio. Back with you, Scorpio. So that's the vibe I'm getting here, but I'm going to pull some more clarifiers. This Six of Swords showed up here on this family and home aisle. Okay, and I feel like if this, you know, it's like somebody here might be going away. Somebody very creative, I don't know. Or like there's like... If there is somebody If there's somebody that you guys suffered a breakup from, okay, there may be like feelings of happiness and romance re-entering your family and home life because you are cutting somebody out and have chose to cut somebody out here, okay? And you know, go away from a queen of, possibly from a queen of swords. For those of you that have had a breakup or some sort of like separation period from somebody in your home or extended family, okay, that you needed to move away from, okay? All right, and for some of you, it may be in a romantic way because I have the Knight of Cups here. Knight of Cups, Six of Swords, Queen of Swords. Okay, so it's like this Queen of Swords, it's like somebody moved away from her towards calmer waters or towards her here. But, and it's something here, okay? And that because of the Six of Swords is up for your choice this week of how to balance your goals. How to rebalance your goals, Six of Swords. Move towards stable, more calmer waters. Okay, all right, let's see here. Give me this star. You may be dealing with an Aquarius. We have the star card here, okay? Or if you have Aquarius in your chart, here you are in your chart as a major. And on the star, I have the Four of Swords, the Lovers, and the Tower. Some of you may have had a breakup in love, or again, there's like some choice here that you're trying to heal and rest and retreat from, okay, about a choice in love that brought a serious tower here, that there's healing around, okay? All right, hold on. Why is the Lovers here? Princess of Pentacles, Ace of Wands, and the Fool. Some of you may be healing from a lost pregnancy, okay? Some of you may be healing from, you know, making a choice in regards to a child or baby here, okay? All right? All right? For others of you, for others of you, you're making a decision, okay, that you've been resting and like ruminating on for a while, okay? And it involves a tower, a tear up of a structure here. And you're either contemplating it now or you have completed it and you're trying to recover from it. Okay? Hold on a second. Why is the tower here? Yeah, if there was like a period of waiting around, okay, it's like you have to blow this tower, Scorpio, and you are familiar with this tower power, okay? You have to blow this tower because it's like Six of Wands, Page of Swords, and the Hang Woman. You could be dealing with somebody with Pisces placements, okay? Or there could be like somebody else's waiting or victory here. It's being watched somehow, or you hear news of it, okay? And it's causing a tower moment for other people, or it's very healing for them, okay? Or for you in one manner or another here, okay? Hang on. For some of you, you may literally be healing, okay, in a phase of healing, and you may have had a shake-up on a self-care aisle here that I already discussed here, that we're like, you're starting to get indicators from your own health and well-being that there needs to be some things that you need to heal or work on here that are like a main goal coming up for you here in this third week of July. And one of them revolves around dropping this Five of Swords-like behavior, closing a book on it. Okay? Some major arcana here. Give me the Eight of Wands here. Yeah. This communication, here's the Six of Swords again. Holy shit. This communication that you fear having communication around, you know, we have the Ten of Cups, the Six of Swords, and the Hermit. Okay? So again, like there's this Five of Swords here, and I already told you, you want to go away from like battles and bickering or anything that's been unfair or kind of crazy, mean, nefarious acts okay? You're looking to close the book on that. Some of them may have been secret or involved a Taurus or a Cancer or somebody with those placements significantly, or you just feel a lot of heavy emotions about them. They could have to deal with work issues or a commitment of yours, all right? A significant commitment of yours, okay, that you really want to heal from this. However, you are afraid to communicate over here because we have the Eight of Wands, or you're afraid in regards to movement. This may be regarding emotional fulfillment within the family, Ten of Cups, and then we have the Six of Swords and the Hermit, okay? And then this Queen of Wands up here showed up over here with the Six of Swords and the Knight of Cups. So literally, you may be faced with the loss of someone, or you're thinking of leaving somewhere, because then we have this Six of Swords here again, all right? And it may have to do with family matters, or putting to move to more calmer waters, or to restabilize family here, okay? Over some, you know, stuff that's been done that you really tried to, you know, maybe go into some introspection on. Some of this may just be you going into a mental and emotional introspection about some things that are really bothering you, okay? And you want to make some changes, and if you can't make those changes, then you are going to Six of Swords this and move on here. And this may be on your mind here on a work front or in several other fronts in your life here that seem to look like they are, they look interrelated. Okay, why is the Queen of Cups here? The Queen of Cups is here because of the Knight of Swords, the Strength, and the Queen of Wands. Okay, so you may be dealing with a Leo here that you're in a significant relationship with. Okay, Queen of Wands with the Strength. Okay. One of your goals is to take action and communicate with this person about some things here. Okay. All right. And there are fears around that communications, because one of your goals is Knight of Swords, Strength, Queen of Wands. And then over here, related to this goal is the Knight of Swords. So you are actually fearing this part of what it takes to do this goal. Okay? And you want to open new doorways is your hope in regards to the goal. You want to open up some new doorway, some new opportunity, some pathway here with the Two of Wands appearing here to take advantage of something, okay? To be able to move towards something, okay? New, brighter things, okay? Here with this Five of Swords, I told you what that relates to, okay? And then down here, there is a fear around exactly what I said. You may have fears regarding happiness and family if somebody goes away, right? Could have to, or, you know, losing somebody. If you're involved with a Virgo, this could be that. Or, you know, you just making moves here, okay? To move towards calmer waters here, okay? And going into a place of deep introspection and communicating about these things. I have twice either fear of movement or communication and or action that involves communication showing up in your fears here, okay? With this star, I see that like a big goal of healing something, okay? And every day and on the inside on a soul level here, okay? Yet there's this tower with it that for some reason has like left you feeling like you're stuck, not being able to do anything, possibly, with this Six of Wands, Princess of Wands, and Hanged Woman here. It's like you're stuck after this tower, which, like, towers are not meant to make you stuck. They're meant to release you being stuck, which is why it gets a little bit confusing here. Or maybe if somebody hangs here too long, then a tower will happen because they won't be stuck. It's getting a little complex on me here. All right, give me, why is the Six of Wands here? The High Priestess, again, with this symbols of Pisces here, the Nine of Pentacles, okay, there's some like secrets, okay, about independence here that are showing up in the reverse, or you feel like you don't have any independence, okay, which is why this tower comes, or why somebody else has a tower moment here. Okay, of some sort or another here about something, okay? What is this? Six of Wands here. Eight of Wands. High Priestess, Nine of Pentacles in reverse, and the Eight of Wands. And it blows a tower. And there's something that you want to heal on an everyday internal level, soul level, and outward level, okay? But there's something here in the energy here that's real screwy here, Scorp. And it could be that your intuition is guiding you to speak more and follow your intuition more about some things, you know, be an independent, free thinker, speaker here a little bit. But you're afraid it's going to blow a tower, okay? But a Scorpio usually will do that if he needs to, okay? But there's something here that you're feeling on a very deep internal level here that's telling you to move, communicate, do something. And yet, I see you here stuck in this hanged woman. So again, this is telling me that this may just be related to somebody that is a Pisces, okay? And it may be that, like, you guys are, you know, like, I don't know, like, there's something here that blows a tower here that could be related to, you know, it's like somebody else's victory, but it's very healing, okay? That it's healing for them and somehow, okay? Let me see. Okay, maybe that somebody took steps towards their own independence here, okay, by following their intuition here, made some moves or some movement, okay, because of a feeling of being controlled here, okay? This could cause a tower, okay? And it could be regarding a choice, okay, that you're trying to heal from. Or you want to heal from, okay? But your goal is to come out of this Five of Swords shit that's happened in the past, and this involves other people, not just you, okay? But I see you wanting to heal it here, but feeling tied up here, unable to do so in one way or another, or unable to move or communicate on it. But okay, the choice is, Scorpio, is Six of Swords. Okay, you got to move to, what's this Six of Swords? Why is the Six of Swords here? I'm going to ask on this Nine of Swords too, because I asked about this other Nine of Swords. Okay, you have repeating things around the draw board here. Four of Pentacles. This Nine of Swords has something to do with holding on to money. Okay, maybe greedily or possessively so. This communication or action that you want to take has to do with that. Or something here. And yeah, Six of Wands and the Sun. Again, with the Leo symbology, okay, there's something you want to communicate about or change or take action on, okay, in regards to holding onto your purse or your mouth or somebody else's, okay? All right, and it's here with Victory and the Sun. Again, another Leo indicator if you're dealing with a Leo. Okay, you may want to communicate with this Leo about finances in one manner or another, okay, here. And you may be involved significantly with this Leo, okay? But these are your goals that are coming up this week or something on your mind going on that you want to remedy or fix, okay, here. That is showing up for you here, Scorpio. I hope this helped. Let me know how it goes. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And let me just see here. What is this red flag on this romance? You get the Ten of Cups in reverse. Again, there's something here that you're fearing over here. You're afraid of movement and communication about it, but you're afraid that something is going to upset a happy family life, okay? Here, on an extended basis, or something here you want to hear. Okay, and there's Ten of Cups is in reverse. Pay attention to red flags, okay? Nine of Cups is in reverse. There's a lack of wish fulfillment and a lack of family harmony right now that's concerning you, okay? And it is also affecting your love life. King of Swords is in reverse. It's bending you way out of shape or somebody else, all right? Or there may be another Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius masculine figure that's acting way out of bounds. Also could be an attorney or an authority figure or somebody involved with the law here that's acting in a reverse manner. that's somehow affecting your love life as well, that is causing you concern. And for some reason, it's tied into family and your wish fulfillment as well. But there's something here regarding what I just said that is causing you a turmoil. What is on this finances and career? Four of Cups, discontent around finances and career. And I already went over that because it's exactly what showed up here. The Wheel of Fortune. You're afraid that fortune, you know, change is spinning and the Wheel of Karma is spinning, and now the Devil popped. So there's something here going on with finances and career, and now Judgment popped. That you feel like you're on the bad side of karma, or somebody else is here on a work front of some sort or another here. It's concerning you deeply. Wheel of Fortune, the Devil, and the Judgment. That's divine judgment, okay? That's an internal calling, literally raising something from the dead, literally like being judged, spiritually judged here, okay? The Devil is here. I don't like that. Something to do with finances and career. And I already went over here what came up on that card. Take it as it resonates. It may involve a significant partnership, okay? Or business alliance, all right, of some sort, okay? What is this Two of Wands? On the Two of Wands, you got the Two of Pentacles, the Three of Cups, and the Five of Pentacles in reverse. So there is some sort of end the world here again. There is some sort of issue here with lack or poverty or abandonment or fear of lack or poverty or abandonment or something here that was unfair that's falling into several categories now here. Okay, and on this Two of Wands, the new opportunities that are part of this goal here with this Queen of Cups that you want to talk about but you're afraid to or take action about have to do with the balance. Okay, Two of Pentacles. Okay. Three of Cups, it could revolve around juggling, but it also could be revolving around rebalancing the scales in some sort or another here financially, in one way or another, and or revolve around family get-togethers of some kind or reunion of some kind or reconciliation. It could involve juggling in a third party here and leaving someone else out in the cold. Okay, it does not have to be on a romantic level, okay, but that's what's showing up here. All right, I hope this helped you guys. Oh, did I clarify on the Six of Swords yet? No, let me clarify that real quick. Clarify the Six of Swords, because that's your choice for the week to balance these goals, all right, with these challenges, hopes, and fears that I've gone over with you, as well as these other things that I've gone over here in each one of these categories. Of course, you guys gave me a really tough read. On the Six of Swords, I get the Six of Swords. I'm not allowed to pull anything else. The choice you have is to move towards more stable, calmer waters. You are in rough waters and various issues in your life here, and they're driving you crazy, really bothering you on an internal level, and you want change. The advice is to make the change. Move to more stable waters, okay? All right? Make the changes that you want here. Sometimes this involves an actual move. Sometimes it's just moving away from these things, which I already went over what those things were, okay, that I see showing up here, okay? You are going to have to initiate action, movement, communication to do so, all right? And the advice here on your choice, and it is a choice. You can do nothing. You can do nothing. But I see something is really eating you up here, okay? Scorpio, I hope this helped. I'm going to clean this up and then I'm going to move to Sagittarius. Have a wonderful week. Let me know how I got to read you these messages, okay? God's reciprocation. I reciprocate with all beings in accordance to the way that they surrender to me. Everyone follows my path in all respects, okay? Material elements. My material nature is made up of 8 separate energies: earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and false ego. Okay? Determination. Those too attached to sense enjoyment and material opulence are enchanted by the scriptural promises of such things. They can never find the resolute determination to perfect their spiritual life. determination, material elements, and God's reciprocation. Okay, I hope you guys have a wonderful week. Okay, let me know how it goes. I will see you guys later in the specialty readings and in your love reading, okay, which we'll post later this week as well. Bye. Sagittarius, how are you?
I just want to make sure.
Yes. We're on. We're on and cooking. Cooking with fire for my fire sign. Holy cow. The readings this week have been insane. The love readings so far, which I haven't gotten to yours, have been insane. If you're going through any issues or you have any other placements in the first few signs or ones I already posted, please go ahead and check those out. Okay, I am pulling some oracles this week, okay, for singles and troubled in love. Maybe that's been the issues that's made me go so far. I have the Observer, Sagittarius. I thought that was Scorpio. It's supposed to be a Scorpio. Maybe you're on the cusp. Anyway, no, there's something you're observing here, okay? That is your thematic theme of what's going on in the inside for the week. I'm going to pull a Lenormand for four different categories of your life for this week. I had electrical problems. Otherwise, this would have been posted yesterday, okay? But I had to have an electrician out yesterday and today to fix several GFIs and receptors and stuff like that. So please forgive me. All I know is that something's going on where it's like, now these are going to take twice as long. Maybe they would have been simpler if I did them yesterday. Finished them all yesterday. Like, I couldn't load. Anyway. Okay. Oh, wow. You got the bouquet on the career front. So, a lot of good tidings at work I see for you, Sagittarius, which is great to see because the past few months, it hasn't been so. I mean, I saw some problems for those of you the past few months that are involved in the service industry and involved in family businesses. Let me just put it that way, okay? If you go back and that's you and you want to go back and take a look, it was all over the place, okay? Especially for those of you in family businesses, okay? We have the house here. A couple other people got the house. We have the house here. We have the mice. Oh my God, I'm so sick of the mice. I don't know what's going on this week, but somebody's putting a lockdown on anybody that's been like in their cupboards this week. People are sick of it. I mean, and only you and Scorpio. So if you're on the Scorpio line, you may want to watch that too. But two other signs got it. The mice, which is indicative of like stealing and loss of money and or like people in your cupboards. You know, sometimes it can be gossip. Okay, you got the whip on self-care. A lot of training here, Sag. Sorry, I almost said Scorp. I just got done with Scorpio. They took a long time, a lot longer than I anticipated. Scorpio always does. Okay, I pulled some oracles for you for single and troubled in love. I think I said that. But I also pulled some other oracles for you just generally. Okay, and I tried to pull two, but you got three, and I wasn't going to give it up. Okay, and you got one in reverse, and I don't usually reread reverse oracles. But for some reason, on any front, okay, I just don't do that. but on any front, this one came out, first of all, you got Elixir of Life and Pure Nature, okay? And everybody knows that a Sag needs to go out in nature sometimes, no matter how hard you're working, Sag, okay? Because you're an explorer, okay? So if you can't move and you work inside or you work inside anywhere, it's very important for your internal health to get outside at some point or another, okay? And I'm seeing that here for you in this upcoming week or this week that we are currently in. Okay, and what came out in reverse was stranded, and it came out in reverse. And it was like, I felt like I should have left it in reverse for some reason, and I don't read reversed oracles. So I don't know if we're going to find out why I did that in this reading. I'm hoping so, because normally I just turn them around. You also pulled lightning, sudden change. Okay, Libra also pulled this. If you're dealing with a Libra or you have Libra placements, you also have the runner in a codependent relationship, and not today. Not dealing, hurt, avoiding conversation, boundaries, still angry. And then you also have dating and healthy choices. Meeting somebody new, dating, get back out there, and making healthy choices and self-love, self-care, and being happier. For those of you that are single or having significant problems, I have romantic feelings and calling in your soulmate. Stay optimistic about your love life and codependency. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. Okay, this is like a repeating pattern theme here going on. Strength is at the bottom. Okay, on your first choice, lover, somebody else got that. One of your first goals, okay, for this week coming up, okay, is the lovers. Who got that? I'll think of it. Give me a hope and a fear related to this choice. Hope, please. The devil. You're hoping to bang somebody. I'm sorry to say, but I'm just feeling like you may be hoping to bang somebody here, Sag. Could be something else. You could be hoping to make a lot of money about a business decision, okay? You could be a little obsessed with somebody that you really, really want, that you feel is like you have some sort of soul tie to, that you may not be with currently because you may be with like somebody sick over here, okay? Because I see two thematic categories popping up over here that are totally on different vibes. And the Three of Wands, you are waiting. You've been waiting for a long time. I feel like there's a buildup here for you, Sag. I don't know what it's about yet. Like, don't give me a crazy reading today, all right? Give me, I need the second goal for my Sag this week, okay? These have taken so much longer than anticipated. So have the love readings, and I just didn't want to ditch anybody. Four of Wands is at the bottom of the deck. Married or in a committed relationship there? Knight of Wands. Oh, Knight of Wands. Knight of Wands is in the goal. You're hoping to spearhead something or someone. Oh, I snorted. You made me laugh. Okay. Thank God one of you can make me laugh today in a reading. Okay. Because they've been heavy. They've been really heavy. Give me a hope and a fear related to this. Don't give me a bunch of sex stuff, okay? This is not like an intimacy reading. I'm reading on every category of your life here, Sag. Page of Swords. Hopefully you're not spying on anybody because you now have the Observer. And as Page of Swords is one of your goals. Could be about a project you want to spearhead or somebody. I didn't say that. All right. Give me another one. Give me a fear. What's the fear, Sag? Oh, no, you gave me two. I'll take two. Oh, no, you've been waiting for so long. To plant a seed. Oh God, this is bad. This is really bad. All right. Hanged Woman and the Ace of Pentacles could have to do with work or somebody you want to spearhead. Real bad that you feel a very hot connection for. Okay. If that's what's going on here, you are like hot in the pants real bad for somebody that you've wanted for a long time. And Sagittarius, you know, you're a mutable sign, but also like you tend to lose interest after a while if you don't get somebody you want. So this may be somebody important, Sag. Hanged Woman and the Ace of Pentacles, okay? But this could have to do with work, okay? Some of you have, like, your ear to the ground on a work project and you're just busting your ass in work, okay? This is, like, this Knight of Wands is, like, full on you, okay? You will work your ass off as this Knight of Wands. Anybody gets in your way, you will run their ass over. But you also have your ear to the ground. It's telling me, like, there's, I don't want to say ulterior motives, but there's like a background to whatever project you're working on. There's like an interior motive. Okay, that's what I'm getting here for you. Okay, give me the choice related to these two goals that my Sagittarius needs to plug into for this week. Give me the choice related to these two goals that my Sagittarius needs to plug into for the week. And it's the Empress. Holy shit. And the Two of Cups. For some of you are in love with somebody you may have not spearheaded yet. I'm just saying, Sag. Two of Cups, Knight of Swords, Two of Swords, Strength, Chariot, Six of Pentacles. And maybe somebody that is like offended by your player ways if you are in that Sag phase, okay? Which not all Sages are that way, I'm just saying. Something's up here. Something is up here. For others of you, you are just like really studying really hard at work. Okay? Okay. There is a divine feminine in the middle of your frickin' read. The Empress. All four queens in one. It's your choice. It's your choice, Sag. Are you going to go get the Empress or not? Are you going to step into your Empress or not? Because what I see here on the periphery, I don't see any queens or kings. So it looks like somebody is like stepping up. And it may be you. maybe you, if you're a big boss, okay, if you're in your divine feminine energy here and you're a big boss, you're a business owner, whatever, if you're in here because Sag is in your 10th house, this could absolutely have to do with your career, okay? If you are a 10th house Sag, you know, or a cusp for Sag, or you have an access point in Sag at the top of your chart, this is about you being a big boss bitch right here, okay? And the Ten of Cups and the Judgment just fell out on that. So some of you has to do with like the whole package. All right, the whole package. Anyway, Sag. Oh my God, thank God you're making me laugh. The Hangwoman and the Ace of Pentacles is like you're waiting to plant a seed here. Okay, you're popping cards on me here. Slow down. Slow down, Sagittarius. You are chomping at the bit here, okay, on several fronts, all right? Again, on the career front, I see stuff going really well for you on the career front. Like, everybody loves you at work. People are very, very happy with you at work. Like, you're a favorite. You're a star right now, okay? Everybody's like, can we get you flowers? Can we get you coffee? Do you want some water? Do you want some this? Whatever you need. If you work remotely, they're like, do you need a new computer? Like, do you need this? Do you need that? What do you need so you can do a better job? We're going to get it for you. You're making people very, very happy. People think you are like somebody to woo at work. Let's not go there yet, okay? But I just mean like on a work front, okay? Insofar as the house, okay? The house here is on the love front, okay? There is a desire to really stabilize your love life here. Okay, singled or coupled, there is a desire to watch your investments, there is a desire to invest in your home, there is a desire to fix it up, there is a desire to buy a home, sell a home, stabilize your life within us and make it solid here with the house appearing here. On the home and family front, you have the mice. So your children may be after your pockets, like especially if you've been doing better, you just feel like you have like an outflux of money on the home and family front. Maybe that's because you've traveled to your family over the summertime. Maybe that's because they've traveled to you. There's been many dinners. It doesn't have to actually be stealing. It's just that like something to do with home and family seems to be whittling away your cupboards, you know, your resources. Okay. It could be emotional resources that they're like chomping into here, okay, with the mice appearing here on the home and the family front, okay? For others of you, it could be actually, you know, somebody who's like, you know, you feel like the give and take is off here a little bit, or like just there's been a lot of expenses related to home and family. If you help support a parent, there may be money going out to that, etc., etc. Okay, on the self-care aisle, see the whip. I love to see the whip for you on the self-care aisle because it basically means you're like retraining yourself emotionally, spiritually, physically. You are at the gym every day, or you're like tapping in spiritually here, or you're learning something new, you know, or alternatively, it could be because of a bunch of arguments that you've had with somebody very significant to you. You need a little self-care. We're going to see though, because we're going to pull some clarifiers, okay? Don't give me an hour reading on a weekly, please. You're like trying to pop all over the place on me. There you went again. Eight of Rods. A lot of movement. I want to talk. Okay. All right. Okay. Hangman. All right. You're pent up about something here, Sag. You got to go for a walk in nature, though, because like whatever was stranded is coming out of stranded mode. I don't know, but I feel like it's a lot of Sagittarius wand energy, like is pent up and getting released out of the gates. Okay. I don't know why I'm feeling that way. I just am for you guys. It's just the feeling I'm getting off these cards, okay? Give me the observer. What is my Sagittarius observing the third week of July? Page of Swords, another observing card. Oh, the Moon is in reverse, and the Seven of Rods is in reverse. Holy shit. Whatever it is, you're deeply emotional about it, or there's some secrets that are coming out, or you're looking into secrets, or you're heavily in your emotions about something that you want to drop your guard for. But you're like emotionally, like if this is love, like you are bent out of shape emotionally over this person. Like you're in your feels bad. That's the truth, Ace of Swords. Oh, I just snorted again. You made me Oh, that's a sign you really made me laugh. Okay, I only do that sometimes. All right, why is the Moon here in reverse? The Four of Rods is somebody you want to marry, or you're already married, Sagittarius, or it's a significant foundation in your work that you're really freaking, you may be working yourself to death right now if you're emotionally off. Okay, you got to get in nature and you got to make sure you get your sleep here, Sagittarius, okay? What is the Four of Wands here? Four. The Hermit. You're not talking about it. You don't want to talk about it, but you're in deep introspection and observation mode on it. Or it's a Virgo, or a Pisces, or a Cancer that you want a significant foundation with. What's this? Six of Cups. It's a soul tie. All right, Sagittarius. Could be about family. Could just be about observing what you want to do here. Taking like a hindsight, forest through the trees, look at what's going on. Same, like I was saying, on this observer thing, it is not just work. So you're either like taking a look. Your emotions are out of sorts about some things and you're trying to go into retrospection, okay, to take a look. Could be about a Virgo that you have a significant connection with, even if it's just a friendship, okay, that you love a lot, okay, that you like care about. For others of you, this may be a love interest that you're like all bent out of shape over watching that like you feel very attracted to. For some of you, it could be. For some of you, there's some old soul tie that you're reminiscing about, that your emotions are out of sort, old or new, okay? That you may not be in communication with, the Hermit, that you're in like a silent look back and see the forest through the trees on here. That's the vibe I'm getting here, okay? And I got the Five of Swords. There may have been like prior battles surrounding this person, okay? Or something of that sort. Oh, Sagittarius, you're gonna give me one of these reads. All these reads have been so long this week, this month, okay. I'll be doing your love reading later this week, okay? And the rest of the signs I haven't done. They've been especially long. Some people are like having a tough time. Definitely cross watch and definitely watch your sun, moon, and rising, okay? Because shit is in the air. Okay, what is the bouquet here for, okay? Who's wooing you at work? Who's like begging to like do whatever you need? Page of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, Ace of Rods. You are fired up about work right now, okay? And doing an excellent job, and everybody sees you as the person that can make it rain. That's what I'm getting here, okay? They see you as an independent free thinker that they need, and they see you as the one that can carry the Page of Pentacles forth to build more pentacles at work, to make the company or the business more money. They see you as highly valuable, okay? There's news about you going around at work that like he, she is the one. Oh, they're the one. Oh, they're like hot. They're hot. They're like not hot like that, maybe, but hot like, you know, you're a hot commodity at work. Like you're being highly valued at work. You have a lot of ideas, new ideas that you're implementing at work, new gigs that you're implementing at work, and you're like highly valued, okay? To the point where people are like, we got to make sure we get her flowers on her birthday. Make sure we don't miss her birthday cake, that kind of thing, okay? Give me this... give me this house here. Hierophant. My deck's upside down. I got the Hierophant, the Queen of Swords, and the Knight of Swords. So I see a lot of communications and actions going into on the love front. Okay, if they haven't already, some swift action and news. Okay, maybe coming in. Okay, you're ready to take some action on the love front here. Maybe somebody with... that you're involved with, that you have a higher commitment with, if you are married, that is a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarian energy, okay? Feminine energy behind the card does not mean that that person is feminine. That person, if you are married to them, may help you with a lot of duties surrounding the home or whatever. Like, you may rely on this person, okay? They may be somebody you go to for advice that you highly, you know, is revered for their advice, okay? Hierophant, Queen of Swords, Knight of Swords. You're going to be talking to this person about taking some like investment actions of some sort, okay? Restabilizing your efforts, you know, your grand plan, the grand opus, whatever it is, if you're in a commitment, okay? For others of you, you may see somebody that you want a stable commitment with that has Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising placements, okay, here, that you deem might be a Queen of Swords or this is you. And you are going to be up front and talk to somebody that you want a commitment with, you want to stabilize with, okay? Especially if you have Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius in your chart, this is probably you, because this is your reading, okay? Take it as it resonates. Give me the you're like acting like Virgo. Three of Swords came out, and it came out in the reverse on that. It was not acting for a card, but you may have had a prior heartbreak with this person, or want to heal a broken heart with this person, or something got messed up here in the jam. Okay, give me this. Give me the rats here. No, they're not rats. They look like rats. They're mice though, but they're big. They look like Nordic rats. If you ask me, it's like a rat. It's like a mouse as big as a freaking cat. That's a Nordic rat. Those things scare me. Seven of Swords in reverse. Wait a minute here. There's something going on with money here where you're trying to be like a little bit sly about something to do with work or a collaboration or a friendship here, or something else going on that you want to plant your seed on. That's some new beginning in the home and family environment that you may not be sharing with everybody right yet. Sagittarius. May have to do with a person that you want to bring into your home and family environment that you haven't talked about yet, that you see significant future interest in, enough to invest in, okay? That you haven't told your family about yet, or somebody else is doing that around you, okay? But this is your reading. Give me this whip. Page of Rods. Eight of Pentacles in reverse and the Five of Cups in reverse. There was like a period of, hold on one second, Sagittarius, I'm sorry. There may have been a period of mourning that you're coming out of, or that you've been grieving quite heavily, that you're trying to engage in a lot of self-care and you need to open up communications on. Maybe something that you involved heavily in, or you want to invest in your self-care a lot to get yourself out of a mourning period after a loss. Could be loss of a relationship, could be loss of anything, could be depression. Just general depression, okay, about some things that you feel like aren't in line in your life, okay? Five of Cups, okay, prior towers that you've had in your life, okay? You want to carry forth news in this way. You may be engaged in some sort of talk therapy or exploration of alternative methods and means to tend to your physical, emotional, and spiritual health right now. That's what I'm getting for you, Sagittarius, okay? Which is beautiful. I love that for you, okay? Oh, my God. It just doesn't stop. I've just had so many. Oh, my God. Hang on one second, Sag. I'm going to pull on this Empress right now. Let's pull on this Empress first. Let's check into her, okay? For some of you, you are the Empress. That is your choice. To embody, fully embody your Empress mode, okay? Whether you're masculine or feminine. And if you're a masculine in here and you have Taurus or Libra as a sun, moon, or rising, this is you, okay? Could be some other Venus placement that's set off highly, especially wherever Venus is right now, okay? This just could be vibing into your Venus, okay? Because the Empress is associated with the planet of Venus, okay? So if you're not any of those, take a look at where Venus is, because a lot of what I discussed today may have to do with where Venus is in your chart, okay, and making a choice to embody that right now for this week, okay? All right, so give me the Empress. The Lovers here, I just don't know. The Hangman, you're stuck, you're waiting, you're trying to like figure out your high place of consciousness, and there's the Queen of Cups. Some of you, this is love. And the Seven of Pentacles about a harvest or an investment with somebody that you want to make that you've been waiting on. You may not be talking to this person. You may have gone into a higher state of being, or this person is into a higher state of consciousness or like being or vibing somehow, and may also have Pisces in their chart. Okay. You've deemed, especially, okay, with the Queen of Cups here. Okay. But this is also a relationship card. You deem this person, you know, this going into this mode has to do with going into this mode in your relationship, okay? Or for you, there's a lot of love here. Seven of Pentacles, you know, that's an investment. Maybe you want to make an investment to yourself. The Empress knows about self-care, okay? She knows she has to invest and take care of herself first, or she cannot be that ultimate manifestor nurturer that she is, okay? What is, again, if one of the other scenarios isn't you, you need to look at your Venus placements, because the Empress is highly tied to Venus, and that's what this choice is about for this week, is embodying that part of yourself. Look at the aspects there too, okay? All right, let's see. Give me the Lovers. Let's go there, because I think for some of you, the Fool, the Moon, for some of you, are about to be parents. and the Nine of Cups. For some of you, you're making choices about fertility or having babies, okay? For others of you, you are, especially if you are feminine and you're about to have a baby or thinking about having a baby, this Empress has to do with you. Okay. For others of you, somebody's thinking about taking a fool's leap here and they're not sharing it with anybody. It's secretive or has to do with a Pisces or Cancer. Once again, this person is wish fulfillment for you. Okay, but you feel a little naughty when you think about them. Or you really want to spearhead them, but you have not ever been with this person, possibly. Or you have a strong sexual attraction to this person. And on the Devil, I just pulled the Devil on that, so I'm not allowed to pull anything else. All right, Sag. All right, give me the Three of Wands. I've been waiting for a long time. On the Three of Wands, you just popped three on me. The Ace of Cups, the Chariot, and the Three of Cups. Yeah, you may have been separated from this person, or you're hoping to have like some sort of reunion with this person. Things may have gotten messed up because of a third party scenario, because I have two threes here, and yeah, you said yes to that because a tower just popped out on that. For those of you that storyline is resonating with, there may have been third party interference in this relationship with this person you've been waiting for so long that you've wanted so bad, okay, and you want a reunion with, and you want to run to Chariot, Ace of Cups. Person makes you hot in the pants, very much so. Okay, but your fear is that you're going to be stuck running here, because this is on the fear aisle. Okay, and then a Six of Wands. Will you have a victory or will you be rejected? There might be some fears of rejection going on here. You're waiting for somebody. You may be waiting for them to come to you. Sag, waiting for somebody to come to them. Did your ego get bruised here, Sag? Or is there something else? There's something else. This person gets you all in your feels. If this is a feels thing, this person to make a Sagittarius back up, what happened here? You're waiting on something before you can go after them. Ace of Cups, Chariot, Three of Cups. You're waiting on something. Ugh. Hang on. Why is the other goal I see here, Knight of Wands? Knight of Wands. Give me the Knight of Wands. The Queen of Pentacles. This person may have Virgo and the Empress. And the Nine of Swords. You are all up in your head about this person you want to go towards. Or for others of you, it's about this like leap towards having a child. Could be for some of you. Okay. You're just very excited about like having a child or something, and you want it to happen like tomorrow. You want to get pregnant like tomorrow. For some of you, it could be, okay? For others of you, again, you want to spearhead a Queen of Pentacles, all right? Two of Cups and the Five of Wands just fell out on that. You may feel like there's competition, and I got two tens just popped out too. Some of you are like super hot for somebody, okay? Oh my God. All right, let me pull one more. Okay. Page of Swords, please. The stars on the Page of Swords. You're watching somebody that might be in the public eye. Two of Cups that you have a significant relationship with or want one with here. What is this Hanged Woman and this Ace of Pentacles? Where does Sagittarius want to plant the pentacle here? Okay. Ten of Cups. Ace of Swords, that's the truth. All right. Oh my God. The Tower and the Knight of Cups. You guys, some of you guys are just like really hot in the pants, male or female, for somebody else. Okay. Even if you are a, I don't know what's going on here. This is not a love reading. You guys are going to get a separate love reading. Okay. Some of you are in separation from somebody that you really, really want, that does may or may not know that you really, really want them. Because you may have fucked it up earlier. For some of you, I'm getting that feeling. Okay, this person is like, represents an Empress and also may have Virgo, Capricorn, Taurian placements, or you do. You're very anxious about this person that you want. Even if it's a masculine you want, this person may have predominant Libra or Taurian placements, especially if they're setting off placements in your chart, Sagittarius, in one way or another here, okay? And then on this Page of Swords, I get like the Star, the Knight of Pentacles and the Two of Cups. You may not be talking to this person. I feel like I already touched on that in some of the other cards. It's like you have your ear to the grindstone here. You want to take slow steps towards this union of one sense or another, okay? Over here on the Hangman, I get the Knight of Cups. You guys have had the most pleasant reading. The Knight of Cups, the Tower, like, I don't know, betting this person, for those of you that that has to do with, it might just, like, bring you a Tower moment here. You're afraid it's going to, like, shake the earth because you waited so long, for some of you. For others of you, this is like really about reinvesting into your home and family and really taking it up a step, up a notch here, okay, on all your creative projects, all right, and also towards family happiness and the choices that you're going to need to make towards family happiness, possibly a rebonding and some bedroom time with your significant other here. Okay, Sag, it looks beautiful. The choice you have is to embrace or go after the Empress. That's your choice. The Hangman. You are in like waiting. How long do you need to meditate on it, Sagittarius? Queen of Cups, Seven of Pentacles. I'll see you.
Hi, Capricorn. I'm here to do your weekly reading. I will be pulling oracles for Singled and Troubled. Okay, I will be pulling some clarifiers on those oracles as needed as we go through. Okay, I'm going to pull a spiritual message for you for the week too. And I'm going to pull a tarot six-pointed star. Okay, these have been rather intense. In addition, I'm going to pull some Lenormands on each four different categories. Okay, for you, all right, home and work. And self and love.
Hope you guys are doing well. I'm sorry about the getting these up. I had to put them in two separate posts because they got so long because they're pretty heavy this week. Okay, I don't know what's going on there, but they're pretty damn heavy. Coming off that week of the moon with Capricorn and Pluto, especially since it had some aspects to the nodes, has been especially, it's just been affecting all the signs, okay? There were a lot of transformation issues going on with the Pluto and the full moon, okay? A lot of stuff with the older generation and parental issues as well popping up. Control, Pluto issues, you know, with control and interference, as well as transformation is popping up, okay? Let's pull your Lenormands, okay, for the third week in July for my Capricorn, please, okay? Those of you that have aspects in the latter decan of Capricorn were probably highly affected by that full moon, okay? May have had some women's issues or mother issues come up for you, okay? And they're obviously also have a world stage right now as well, okay? So for my Capricorn, please. For career and work, we have the Tower for career and work, okay? Some of you may literally work for government or have dealings with government or bureaucracy on one end or another that's either holding up some of your projects or just or protecting your projects, okay? Take it as it resonates. I am going to pull some clarifiers on it as we go through, all right? For love, we are popping with the birds, okay? This can be about a lot of news coming in on a love front, okay? Can be a lot of gossip surrounding your love life, Capricorn, okay? This is for sun, moon, rising, and any stellums in Capricorn, okay? Or whatever, north node, whatever placements you guys particularly like to check. We have the sun, which we love, okay? For home and family. So it does look like either some things are going to be illuminated on a home and family front, okay, especially with that moon, there may have been some things illuminated insofar as home and family, because the sun was in Cancer, natural ruler of the fourth house of home, okay. For others of you, it may be a very shiny place, okay. On the self aisle, we're getting the mountain, so there are some challenges here insofar as self is concerned that may have come up for you guys around the time of the full moon and, you know, popping off into this week, okay, the third week of July, that are heavy in one area of another. There may be challenges to your own ability to institute the self-care that you want, or some really large goals that you need to hit to take care of, okay, on a self aisle, okay, spiritually, physically, emotionally, mentally, here, Capricorn, for the third week in July. With the mountain appearing here, there are some challenges. Okay, we're gonna look into it, okay? We have playfulness, passion, express your love, and unrequited love here on the popping up for those of you that are singled and troubled, okay? There does look to be like an interest, some interest here. Okay, I have the sword and the rose popping, clarity, truth, revelation, solidarity, force, honor, protection, and power, kisses and coffee cup, okay, that is indicative of some light get-togethers. We also pop in here with ascending and wedding rings, okay, and abundance is at the bottom. Those look pretty powerful, okay, so we're going to see here, for my Capricorn, for the third, everything's pre-shuffled, for the third week in July, this will post with all six of the latter half of the zodiac, okay? I already posted Aries through Virgo, and it is chaptered and bookmarked. For those of you that have any other placements, please always check those. Goal one for my Capricorn for the third week of July. Four of Wands. There may be a lot of communication surrounding love if you guys are involved in marriage of some sort, or the breaking of a marriage, or serious, serious commitment here. Or somebody that you've identified that you would like a serious commitment here with, okay? Justice is popping as the first goal for you, okay? That's a major arcana card, okay? Associated with the sign of Libra, if you have any Libra placements or are dealing with a Libra, this person could be popping here. Alternatively, you guys may have some sense of rebalancing the scales here going on. Hold on. What's the hope and fear surrounding this goal? Eight of Cups. There's a hope. Some of you are walking away from something in your lives, okay? A fear is Ace of Wands. Fear about new beginnings after this walk away, okay? I will be pulling clarifiers. I want a second goal for my Capricorn. Six of Swords. That is a going away, actually moving, traveling, or just saying goodbye to something here is really popping up for you guys. Can I have a hope and a fear surrounding this? You pop two on hope, so I'll keep them both. The Nine of Pentacles, independence, and the Eight of Wands, communication about that independence and or movement, travel, actual physical movement, or a lot of messaging and communications, okay? I see this popping up with the birds here. Like I said, the birds can be positive, you know, and be about bringing things back to the nest. Can also be a lot of gossip and gossip around the home specifically, and here popping in the love lane around love. Can I have a fear? The Wheel of Fortune is showing up here in a fear related to the Six of Swords, okay, revolving you or someone else, moving and going towards calmer waters. Can I have, for my Capricorn, for the third week of July, can I please have the choice involved? Queen of Cups. And the Fool is at the bottom, taking a leap. The Fool, the Four of Pentacles, the Hermit, the Two of Pentacles, and the King of Pentacles, wow, and the Queen of Pentacles, and the Seven of Swords is behind that. I do feel like there's something going on here that's popping off insofar as a domesticated partnership here, Capricorn, that is, you know, really huge for you in some manner or another, whether you're still in the relationship or not. You may be taking a fool's leap towards somebody else, okay? It may involve a Virgo, or you have Virgo placements in your chart, or somebody else with a lot of earth energy, okay? For others of you, it may have been an improper leap, but you guys do have some positive cards over here for single and troubled in love. So there may be some sort of break, a new thing going on, or transition happening here. Okay, your spiritual cards were approaching guru and calm meditation. Okay, calm meditation says, as a lamp in a windless place does not waver. So the yogi whose mind is focused remains always steady in meditation on the transcendent self. Okay? This might be a challenge for you with what's going on here in this mountain aisle. You may be realizing that you need to do a lot of inner work and it's mind-boggling to you. On this approaching guru, it says, just learn the truth. Approach a guru with humility. Inquire from them submissively and render service. The self-realized can impart transcendental knowledge, for they have seen reality. So there may be somebody around that you feel is spiritually connected or advanced, or just, you know, would give you advice, Capricorn, from a very protected place and space, okay? This doesn't have to be traditional guru that you would, you know, say, oh, I'm gonna, you know, my local priest or my local pastor or my local rabbi. It could be, okay? It could be. It could also be somebody else, okay, that's representative of the qualities that you just really admire and trust insofar as advice here, okay, that's coming your way or that you learn of in the third week of July that you want to go to for some advice or help, okay, or listen to, okay? We have day and night and white rose of hope. So I do feel like elixir of life and keys on a tree. Okay, I'm gonna start clarifying this. There's obviously a lot of transition here with the Justice card as a major arcana. Another goal being actually looking like it's to activate this major arcana to bring some sort of balance. With the Queen of Cups in the middle, okay, your ability to meet your goals, okay, and balance your hopes and your fears, okay, is going to have to do with stepping into this Queen of Cups role. Okay, this could be a relationship card going forward with a relationship that you really want to pursue. That you may not be in now, or coming from a place of deep sensitivity and knowing, okay, tapping into your own intuition, okay, and being sensitive to others as well, Capricorn, okay, and loving, and the Queen of Cups is very, almost has a deep intuition and psychic ability. It's also a relationship card. Okay, I want to find out about this bureaucracy because there's something here going on with this bureaucracy and justice, possibly. For some of you that work in law enforcement, military, or the justice system, this could just be popping justice here because of that. However, if it is, I see that there is a change in jobs related to that, possibly. If that, for those of you that that resonates with, it's like phasing out of one part of it into another. The Queen of Wands is popping out. Okay. Give me this tower here for my Capricorn. The Wheel of Fortune, the Queen of Wands, and the World. There's something here with your career, okay, that you may feel is cutting off your passion, or that it's time to close out a cycle, okay, or begin a cycle. Okay, but that you're held up here with a little bit of red tape, that the indicators here are that this may be changing for you, or you may feel cut off from this Queen of Wands because of bureaucracy or red tape, okay? But this is, why is the Queen of Wands here? Queen of Cups, ooh, this is somebody you really want, possibly, okay? Quite possibly. Quite possibly there is a boss-like figure or somebody you really admire that you want to team up with in career here, okay? Or this is you, and but I see this as something more, okay? If you have a partnership or you want to team up with somebody in work and career, there may be some bureaucracy or stuff like that that you guys are dealing with right now if you are involved in a love relationship. Okay, that you also have a okay, for some of you, if some of you are in the public eye in one way or another, okay, you may be dealing with protecting your business in one way or another this week. This could be, okay, it may be time for you to do that. With the Wheel of Fortune indicated here, you may be at a level in your career where you need to do that in some way or another. Okay, that could be joining a union, okay, the Screen Actors Guild, or that could be, you know, registering a patent or trademark. That could be, you know, anything that to do with protecting your intellectual property or skill or service set here could be indicated, especially if you are in a creative field, okay, where you have a stage of one sort or another related to that field, or it's public in one way or another, okay, could be indicated here. Alternatively, there may be somebody else that you want to team up with here, or just really, hang on, I'm going to pull some more on this before I speak anymore, because this is rather intense, and hang on, I do have a lot of action here being taken as insofar as this bureaucracy is concerned. It is time to do so, if this is resonating in that manner. I see that it's time to do so, okay, with the Knight of Wands and the Knight of Pentacles here, okay? Alternatively, you could want to go really fast, or someone else does, and there's like a conflict between going fast and slow on one instance or another. Okay, hold on. What is this? Karma is like, karma and timing are definitely involved here. Why is the World here? Why is the World here? Knight of Swords, Five of Pentacles, and the Five of Wands. There's some ending here, okay, with red tape or bureaucracy for some of you guys. There is, okay? There's some action that needs to be taken, or some action that's going to come about this week, okay? It could be related to this person, if it's not you, okay? Where there's been lack or competition of some manner or another, okay? And there may be some news or action arriving that may or may not be fortuitous for you, or you had an ending with this person and now you have something going on here with red tape. Yeah, death just popped out. You had an ending with this person. You're not in this person's life currently. And maybe you want to be again. For some of you it is, okay? Because the Queen of Cups is also showing up here, okay? This person is very attractive, may have some sort of platform, that, and there may be a lot of activity and action going on with this person, okay, insofar as their own career and business is concerned, okay, that the wheel of fate and fortune are spinning on, okay, in a positive manner. However, you may have done something. You may have left this person out in the cold, and now be re-examining that in one way or another, or you have something coming back around with this person that may bring up some things that you did in far as this relationship is concerned that are not particularly enlightening for you. Okay. Let's pull on this Justice. I'm gonna pull a different deck to do that just in case this pops here, because this is kind of heavy. Like everybody else's reads this week, this is heavy. Everybody's giving me a really heavy read, and I don't want to leave you guys with it and just be like, oh, well, this is that, and have a nice day. Because it doesn't look, you know, just too many major arcana for me to do that to you guys. Give me the Queen of Cups here. Again, this Queen of Cups is showing up here with the Seven of Swords, the Sun of Swords, and the Temperance. There may be some news or action that you want to take, okay? You need to do... Why is the Seven of Swords here? Something went on here that may have been secret or was really heartbreaking insofar as a relationship is concerned, okay? This Queen of Cups may have predominant Pisces in their chart if they're not you. If you have predominant Pisces in your chart, this may be you. However, what I see here is Capricorn, the Seven of Swords, the Sun of Swords, and Temperance, okay? And there may have been some lying, stealing, cheating in regards to a relationship that is on your mind, or to the fore, the third week of July here, okay? where there was heartbreak, you know, and possibly some secrets. Could be concerning a child. Does not have to be. Okay? Or some news related to money. Something happened here related to money, okay, that may have caused heartbreak in a relationship, okay? Double dealing of some sort or some sort of nefarious acts where you really need to hone in on your intuition here, okay? Hold on a second. Why is the nest here on the love front? Mother of Swords, Death, and the Ace of Swords. Somebody may have cut you off here, or there may have been some truth spoken, or some legalities, once again, that are involved in this here, okay? And it may be the wrap-up or ending of these items, okay? Or these things may need to transform. There may be need to cut off some gossip, or there was gossip here, all right? And there was a cut-off. You know, to truth coming through, okay, in relation to this gossip, okay, that there is an ending here on a love front. Queen of Swords, Death, and the Ace of Swords. Somebody may have cut you off due to yours, or you may have cut somebody else off due to their lying, gossiping on some front here, on the love front here. There is a time of transformation. And a time where you may be cutting other people off that have gossiped about you as well. Okay, if you know which side of this you're on, okay? Why is the sun here on the home and family front? Justice in reverse.
Yeah.
Justice in reverse, the Emperor and the Father of Pentacles. So here again, I do believe that there is something that's being illuminated on a home and family front or gossip related there too. And it could be related to you, Capricorn, or a significant father figure or someone that you are in a domesticated partnership with and are divorced from. Okay? Something that's coming to light here on a family and extended family level here due to some injustices. Okay, and those injustices may have been as to you, okay? However, for some of you, you may have been the trigger for that injustice, okay? So if it's you, Capricorn, these things are coming to light the third week in July. It may be rather heavy here for you, for these things to come to light, okay? What is the mountains here? Yeah, there's may have been some sort of cutoff or loss here or challenges here related to that you're healing from, related to this with the mountain appearing here in the third week of July. We have the mountain in the upright, the mountain, and then we have the star in the upright, and then we have the Nine of Wands, which is the wounded warrior in the reverse, and the Ace of Pentacles in the reverse. There may have been a loss of some kind here. All right, on a brand new promising beginning of something tangible, okay, that you're healing from currently, all right? And you may feel like it's not all going to be healed the third week of July. You may feel like there is a lot of healing that needs to be done, okay? Part of that healing requires that you drop your walls, okay, a little bit to go forward and heal here. There may have been something to do with money that was deceitful or deceptive, or a job or opportunity that was taken that's now lost, where it's tearing you up on the inside a bit here. Okay, why is the Ace of Pentacles here? This Ace of Pentacles could have had to do with it's in reverse, and this Ace of Pentacles for you, somehow with this Ace of Pentacles, a victory here was blockaded here, okay, as well as a significant relationship with the Two of Cups appearing here. I have a Six of Wands, the Seven of Wands, and the Two of Cups. Somehow something got messed up here with a brand new divine offer, okay? A gift from above that could not be tapped into here properly. It may have been blocked because of another relationship, All right. Or your ego may have gotten in the way of taking hold of this Ace of Pentacles and this Two of Cups. There may have been a loss of a relationship that was of significance to you that would have been a victory but was blocked off somehow because of ego here. Also could have been because of something that happened here, okay? For those of you that are, you know, hang on a second. Why is the Seven of Wands here? Empress in reverse. And the Lovers. Some of you may have made a choice in love that cut you off from your own value or sense of value. For others of you, you may have been cut off from a feminine figure or made a bad choice in love. Okay, here with the Empress being in reverse, you may have lost a feminine figure, okay? You may have your own mother wounding or issues that are coming up here. Okay, but for a lot of you, this involves some choices that you made, that you're healing from, that you're torn up on the inside, okay? Just put an end to a brand new beginning or start that you had going, okay? Some of you may have made a choice between two women and feel like you chose the wrong one. Why is the Empress in reverse? On this, I get the Three of Pentacles, the Six of Swords in reverse, and the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. There may have been some other work collaboration or decisions you made on other friendships that blocked you off from this love relationship in one way or another, okay? But our family scenario that you're in now that's unhappy and not providing what you wanted, with the Empress in reverse and the Ten of Pentacles in reverse and the Six of Swords in reverse suggests maybe that you didn't walk away from something that should have been walked away from a long time ago. Let's see. What is the Lovers here for? Mother of Pentacles, the Hermit, and the Moon in reverse. Again, this has to do with a masticated partnership of some kind or another where there was a break or you're going through a break now or there's a finalization or there's a recap of this breakup because it's coming up for some reason because now you're realizing you made some improper decisions, maybe treated somebody unfairly or unjust. And the Hierophant is popping out on that. There you may or may not. And the Four of Pentacles, you may have, again, held on to some things that you shouldn't have held on to too long that interfered with this relationship or didn't let go in the way you should have that interfered with this relationship or potential beginning with an Empress. Okay, either you didn't value this person or they didn't value themselves properly or you made a choice between two and it was the wrong choice. Okay, the Moon here on this Lovers, I got the again, with there's a possibility that emotions are really out of whack here for you on this thing, really hurting, and your intuition was off with the Moon in the reverse. For others of you, there are secrets coming out in regards to your involvement here, Capricorn, or just being revealed to you slowly but surely with the Lovers, the Mother of Pentacles, the Hermit, and the Moon in reverse. The Hermit is in the upright. So this person may be have prominent Virgo in their placements. I think I said that before because it already popped out once. Or Pisces. Or Cancer. But they're also, this also may be you. Okay, especially if you have that as a Sun, Moon, or Rising and are in here checking for another part of your chart. Okay? Then you are this figure. Okay? And there's another Father of Pentacles who did not treat you right or you had a previous divorce or separation from. Okay? Take it as it resonates. Okay? But insofar as the Capricorn section of your chart, this is what's happening, you know, that I see going on here. All right? Let me pull down here and then I'm going to go. I do see hope here because we have the White Rose of Hope. Day and night. So there's some big change. Literally, Elixir of Life, keys on a tree, day and night. I feel like there is hope here, but there's something you need to tap into, and you need to be willing to tap into this mountain to get to the changes you want. You've got to be willing to get into this mountain, okay? And the mountain, sometimes that requires a fool, a hermit, and strength, okay? And, you know, there may be a significant Virgo involved that, you know, or somebody with Virgo placements, or you tapping into your own Virgo placements, especially if you have Virgo in your chart, to seek the answers somewhat, to cross this mountain on a self-care aisle here, to deal with what has gone on. Okay, give me the fates here. No, give me this justice. And then there's a need for real calm meditation here. On justice, I get the Page of Cups, the King of Swords, and the Five of Swords. So again, if you have, if you are at the Aquarius Capricorn line, or have things at the Aquarius Capricorn line, or have Aquarius or, you know, other air sign in your chart here, on this justice, I have the Page of Cups, the King of Swords, and the Five of Swords. So I feel like there is some justice to this situation, okay, by admitting defeat and walking away. In some instances, you need to admit defeat and walk away and bring an apology or offer to somebody. You may need to bring an apology to someone. You may need to move swiftly to do that. You may need to bring an apology to somebody, or somebody's bringing an apology to you, especially if they're a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, okay? If this is you, you know, you may want, hang on a second. What is this Eight of Cups? You may need to make some, on the Eight of Cups, we have the Three of Cups, the Queen of Cups, and the Four of Swords. The hope here, Capricorn, is to walk away from something, and it may be another relationship, okay? Or third-party interference with a relationship, okay? And everyday, practicing everyday healing to do that. If this is you showing up at this Queen of Cups, you are walking away from third-party situations that used to be hurtful here so that you can heal, and that's a necessary thing for you to do, okay? You showed up here with a fear, okay, of the Ace of Wands, and my clarifiers on this Ace of Wands were the Emperor, the Eight of Swords, and the World. Okay, you may have a fear about new beginnings taking root, okay? If somebody does bring you an apology, you may fear getting emotionally involved with them again because they left you all tied up for a certain, you know, in your mind, and you want that to be over with, okay? Or because you've released yourself from this Emperor, boss or daddy-like figure, maybe a baby daddy, maybe a boss-like figure, you know, or you have a fear. Capricorn, for some of you, you could have a fear about truly stepping into this role, maybe because of other experiences you've had, okay? Why is the Eight of Swords here? But the thing here is that you've got to drop your... You may have abandoned somebody, or somebody... There's an end to this person's abandonment with the Five of Pentacles showing up in the reverse here, and or languishing too long in the pain of it here that's going on and being processed here. Seven of Wands in reverse, Five of Pentacles in reverse, Nine of Rods in the upright on this Eight of Swords. This is some major, like, interior walls, abandonment issues, you know, blockade issues, where you feel exposed, to where you are presenting yourself in a Nine of Rods stance, okay, because you feel like you can't stand on higher ground or put your guard up, okay, in regards to maybe the abandonment of somebody or ill treatment of somebody, okay, because we also have had the Five of Swords show up here, okay, the World appearing here on this Ace of Wands. It appears that this cycle is closing out, okay, there is a chance for a new beginning for this person or you, okay, but you've got to be sensitive. You've got to tap into and move from a place of love, Queen of Cups, not a King of Swords, Five of Swords energy. Okay. Or this, you know, is you. But again, something here was unfair, unbalanced, and one of your goals is to rebalance and fix this. What is this World here for? Two of Swords, the King of Cups, and the Fool. Again, you may feel like you're not going to be able to get somebody back that you want to go back after because you made an improper decision. Okay, for some of you. all right? Or you're not willing to take anybody else back, you know? And maybe you used to be at a crossroads over this person for a long time. You know, this person may come and try and get you back, or you may be trying to get somebody else back here, because this Ace of Wands is a fear. This person may come and try and reconcile with you, all right, and take a fool's leap, or you feel like a cycle is closed and you can't get to that because the chapter's closed and the world is on this now, okay? You may be looking at somebody else, fearing that their new beginning and what has occurred in the past has cut you off from this person, okay, because of the things that you did, or you waited too long, or you made a bad decision. That's a fear, you know? I mean, that is a fear. You can choose to live in that fear, or you can choose to try and bring balance to the situation and go after what you want to rebalance the scales. The advice is Queen of Cups, okay? Of the Queen of Cups to what? You know, to try and heal a broken heart on some level here. All right, it may have been related to some fast, swift action that may have been hasty, may have involved lying, stealing, cheating, and manipulation, okay, to bring news of that or discuss it, okay, might be necessary here if you want to meet your goals. It's your choice whether you want to or not, okay? This involves love, because I have a King and a Queen of Cups, a King of Cups on this side, a Queen of Cups on this side. For you here, Capricorn. So for some of you, this revolves around a significant relationship, maybe one that you're breaking off, or one that you felt like you made some bad choices in. And if you want to fix the situation and meet these goals, give me the, why is this the Wheel of Fortune here? Again, I'm getting that you fear your goal. You do have a goal of independence and or speaking to a pre-empress energy. Maybe somebody with Virgo, Capricorn, Taurinian placements that is very independent now and single. Okay, what is this phase? Ooh, there you are. On the Fates, we pulled, which is the Wheel of Fortune here, the Five of Cups, the Devil, and the Six of Cups. So you have a fear, okay, about losing this person, okay, or about the loss of this person, the mourning of this person. The Five of Cups with the Devil and the Six of Cups. This felt like a soul tie to you that you feel like you may have lost or royally screwed up. For others of you, you may just be mourning something, the loss of a relationship for whatever reason. This may have come up heavy for you, and it may just be in your mind that some internal healing with an old relationship came up, okay? That I can see it playing out that way for some of you, okay? That you're really having to go into your emotions to process these things that have recently come up. This could be an old divorce where the children are grown, and for whatever reason, maybe one of your children just had a child of their own. And for whatever reason, it brings up all these memories of your prior relationship and divorce, and the reprocessing of some of those things. Maybe because, you know, you had more interaction with this person, okay? I see that playing out for a small percentage of you that way. For the rest of you, I see that there is some real bad behavior here that went on, and you guys want to rebalance the scales. Maybe some cold cutoffs, vindictive behavior, lying, stealing, cheating, manipulation, all right, related to a pre-empress energy. This is Virgo mutable earth energy, okay? This person is single. Ace of Cups is at the bottom of the deck. There may have been another Capricorn involved here, okay? Again, and with this showing up here in the fear, I show a fear around the mourning and what you did wrong, with the Devil appearing here in this manner and the Six of Cups, okay? And you're afraid that the Fates, that the Wheel of Fortune has spun against you here, and maybe timing is not in your favor now to heal these things. But the message from the universe is that it is, and that they're, you know, with the Queen of Cups, you're going to have to step into an emotional state here and approach somebody emotionally if you want to try and heal what you've done, and honestly and sincerely, if it's you, okay? If it's you. If it's not, to continue to stay in this place of emotional vulnerability to heal. And this place of emotional vulnerability may have been very difficult or felt very emotional to stay in, especially during last week's full moon. If you have a ascendant in Capricorn, You had a very emotional experience with this full moon, okay? If you had, especially if you're in the latter decan, High Priestess, like your intuition is popping on this, okay? You know, and there may be secrets, all right? Again, there may be a Pisces, but your intuition may have really been on fire, as well as a deep, very deep emotional state and a realization last week that you are at a mountain that you is both boiling over and feeling extremely restricted in your heart space at the same time last week may have occurred, okay? If you are in here because you have a sun in Capricorn in the 10th house, this may have played off in your love life and in your career, okay? If you have this in Capricorn, again, some items in partnership may have been illuminated recently with this sun in Cancer, okay, and various partnerships that are coming out into the light. Out into the light, Capricorn, okay? They may be very hurtful. There may be involved deep emotions and secrets that you were unaware of, or some things that you did, especially if you're in the latter decan of Capricorn, okay? Because of the transition from the 12th house into the first house with Pluto being there. That's massive transformation, okay? And things come to light, okay? And it calls for internal transformation, okay? Any attempts to control through improper means, abandonment of people, you know, vindictive behavior, Five of Swords behavior, King of Swords, cold-like behavior, where there should not be cold and callous behavior. There's karma attached to those, okay? That's not the positive transformation and healing powers of Pluto. Okay, so let's just pull real quick, and that can come up in you or other people, okay? So I'm not saying that you're the perpetrator here, okay? But for some of you, you are, and this spread that's popping up here. Nine of Pentacles is popping again. Some of you may need to get your independence to go after somebody that you really, really like, and it may feel like there is a mountain due to bureaucracy, gossip, and things being illuminated. What is this death here for? Yeah. Five of Rods, Ace of Rods, Page of Rods. Again, like this death and transformation, there may be needing for you to be the instigator to cut off unnecessary gossip if you are involved in it or you hear it. You know, you need to step up and tell the truth and cut off gossip and not participate in nefarious things. Again, I see that there might be competition around a person that you wanted, that you felt very passionate for. Okay, Five of Rods, Ace of Rods, Page of Rods. There may be have been an ending here with a person that you very much wanted due to incoming gossip, or again, this could be related to a prior relationship that if you're older and have grown children are coming back up because you're having a grandchild for the first time, or you're running back across this person or have to interact with them due to other grown children that you have, and for whatever reason, these emotional cleansing is popping up here, okay? But I do see Day and Night, Keys on a Tree, Elixir of Life, and White Rose of Hope, and I do feel for some of you, you have somebody that is very connected in your life that you could connect with more, that would give you a lot of sense of peace and love here, okay? And some of you may have felt let down by a sense of, I have unrequited love here, okay? Let's pull on that real quick. So there may have been somebody that you very much wanted that either the feelings weren't reciprocated or you just couldn't do it for some reason. And it may have been because of something you did to screw it up or other people's interference here. Okay, but there is a message to go forth from do not let it kill your heart. Do not let it kill your sensitivity. Six of Pentacles is falling out in reverse. You know, there may have been, you may have not properly given and taken because of your own fears here. Okay, but the thing is, you know, the advice here for those of you, it says playfulness, passion, and express your love and unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. For those of you getting out of a relationship, you know, or who have gotten out of a relationship again, there's a need, you know, Nine of Wands, you feel like a wounded warrior just thought, okay. But there's a need to end that, to free yourself from your self-imposed imprisonment of the mind here. And I see that here with this Eight of Swords, Nine of Rods, the Seven of Wands, and the Five of Pentacles. I feel like some of you feel like a wounded warrior and afraid to approach this person or afraid of passion with this person because you may have left them out in the cold or they left you out of the cold. You feel vulnerable because of something that happened, maybe something that you did or other people did that you're afraid to talk about. But if you want to heal it, you're going to have to come from a real, honest and emotional state and place. Queen of Cups in the upright is your choice to meet your goals, to bring balance and justice to this situation where there was an injustice. And I do see that there was an injustice. Okay. Give me this unrequited love. Nine of Pentacles. This Nine of Pentacles has popped so many times. I feel like Six of Pentacles and the Strength. There may be somebody that is exhibiting extremely independent behavior that's you know, pre-empress energy is basically an empress that's not married, that's single, okay? That exhibits, you know, the behaviors of, you know, that is abundant on her own, you know? You know, and I have here the Six of Pentacles and the Strength, and there may have been improper give and take with this person. Or you may have just, hold on, felt like this person didn't want you, but I also feel like something else happened here. Yeah, Three of Swords. That this person left you out in the cold, okay? I'm not sure if that's true by what I'm seeing here, because I'm seeing there's a lot of other shit involved, and maybe some shit you did to screw this relationship up and self-sabotage it on some level yourself, okay? For others of you, you know, you are this person, and maybe your ex wants you back, and you're like, yeah, no, because it doesn't look like they were very healthy, okay? And you have to say no, and, you know, you are afraid that you've lost a chance with somebody else, quite possibly, that you very much wanted here, okay? Or whether you're going to be able to get over some of these old pains that are coming up, you will. You will, Capricorn, okay? A Capricorn is the goat, right? He's meant to climb this mountain. He's made for it, okay? It may not be on a material level or a easily definable goal level right now for you. And all you need to do, Capricorn, to fix that is to handle it like any other goal you have that you take goat-like action on in your life, right? Because you are the goat. You can pretty much do anything you set your mind to, and you don't give up on it. You are made to cross this mountain. This mountain is calling out for you to heal. Okay? Alright, I believe in you guys. Let me know how it goes. There is also calm meditation and approaching guru. Okay? So definitely need to tap into this mountain here to fix this, and a upright Queen of Cups. Whether that means going after somebody relationship-wise, okay, that's a potential for you. That you're very scared to do because the feelings are very strong, so you're afraid of getting hurt. Yeah, the time is still now if that person is, you know, to dip your, you know, but you've got to come from this emotional heart space, okay? And for others of you, it's just, you know, staying in tune with your own sensitivity and stuff and not, you know, to heal here. All right, let me know how it goes, Capricorn. I'll be thinking of you guys. When I was cleaning up, I realized that we did not clarify your Six of Swords, which was at the bottom, okay, in regards to the goal here, okay. I know the Queen of Cups is in the middle, and I clarified the rest around it, but I just want to clarify this Six of Swords for you here, okay, because that requires taking action to move towards calmer waters. I know it involves exactly what I said with the Queen of Cups, but I just want to see if we can get some more on that specifically for you. Four of Swords, Hierophant, Nine of Cups. Yeah, it is like you need to move to more calmer waters here. You may have been sleeping on taking action to leave a place, and maybe a physical place if you are in a breakup, okay? And maybe relative to you taking those steps in the self-care, okay? Just like a goat would with any other task that's easier for a goat to lay out and make goals for, okay? It may involve an actual move if you're involved in a breakup, or ending something, all right? Here we have healing, so you may have been sleeping on this. Sleeping on this, move towards calmer waters, okay? We have the Hierophant here, indicating that, you know, you have divine protection to do so, okay? And or a higher calling to do so. Your intuition is calling out to you, God is calling out to you here, okay? To go towards your wish fulfillment here, okay? And that may be an independent wish fulfillment, because the Nine of Pentacles has popped up several times. So this could be you, you know, independent, okay? Independent wish fulfillment on every level here in this pre-Empress energy and this Nine of Cups, okay? Well, let's see here. Or you, some of you may be healing. Some of you may be healing from addiction issues as well, or health issues, self-care issues here that are calling for you to heal. Let's see, what is this Four of Swords? Yeah, it's, some of it is bringing an apology to somebody else. This may be a sister or another feminine energy. It doesn't have to be a love interest. For some of you, I think it is, okay? But it says, you know, this on this Four of Swords, it's like you've been sleeping on taking action and communication towards what? This Page of Cups here, that's an apology or some sort of offer towards somebody you admire. Who is that? The Queen of Rods. All right? For others of you, you may have been sleeping on your own progression here, okay? That'll reignite your Queen of Wands energy, all right? Okay? Or you're healing from information or news, okay? In regards to something else, that somebody maybe that you deem... Who is the Queen of Wands here? Let me ask. Some of you are healing from a marriage breakup. Again, I already said that. Okay, with the healing and the Hierophant and the Nine of Cups here, you know, it looks like if you do have to break up, that it is towards your ultimate wish fulfillment, that it will be fulfilling for you. Okay? Yeah, okay. This Queen of Rods and this Page of Cups. On this Queen of Rods, I get the Page of Swords, the Ace of Cups, and the Temperance in reverse. There's some sort of thing that you feel very impatient about, okay? Some of you, this may have to do with a child, especially if the child's an air sign. High Priestess just fell out on that. There may be some secrets involved here, okay? Again, I think I've said that before. And the Queen of Cups. Holy shit. This is getting a little bit finite, and it won't apply to all of you, but for those of you that it does, I want to get this for you. Why is the Temperance in reverse here? This is your own feelings of abandonment about a King of Pentacles. Some of you have fears around abandonment and or an actual abandonment that happened of you, okay? The King of Pentacles is in the upright. The King of Rods is in reverse. There may be some secrets involving this. If you did any running around, this could be you. Okay, otherwise this could be, you know, King of Rods in reverse is, Six of Swords is just fell out in reverse. And like the Six of Swords is in the upright here. So you need to move away from this behavior if this is you. Okay, others of you, you know, you have delayed moving away or taking action steps here. Okay, maybe because of a child and a significant commitment, could be a marriage, okay? But the Temperance in reverse is like, especially, yeah, Eight of Pentacles, you've invested a lot of work in this, okay? But something's off here with the Temperance in reverse and the Ace of Cups. It can also point to addiction issues, okay? For those of you, I've already said, for those of you that are, that there's like this mountain in the self-care aisle, there's something that hurts real bad. Lovers is in reverse. There may have been an improper decision in love. Choice between two that you feel like you didn't make properly. Okay. Eight of Rods, a lot of communication, okay, or downloads are like popping into your mind here with this right now, or bothering you, or you need to move. Six of Swords, Eight of Rods. Okay, for those of you that are sober, you may be afraid of relapse. For some of you, you could. Strength just popped out. That's another, you know, strength with temperance is like for people in the recovery. This is a serious thing here, okay? Why is the strength here? Because temperance is in reverse, so there may have been a relapse here that's of concern to you. Three of cups and the two of rods. Again, there may have been maybe some temptations recently, okay? An offer towards temptation related to a third party or related to something here, okay? Yeah. What is this? Why is the King of Rods here in reverse? Because now I have a King and a Queen of Rods, okay? Eight of Cups. This is somebody you need to walk away from or walked away from you. The world, there's an ending, a breakup with this person, okay? Or this is you. Four of Cups, you're very discontent. There's other Aces of Cups on offer that you can mix that you're not noticing. Other opportunities that you're going to come about that you can't notice because you're still too focused on the three cups you're unhappy with. But there's a reason you're unhappy with those three cups, and it's because your internal soul is off right now. And for some of you, Seven of Cups, yeah, you're afraid of getting disillusioned by options in regards to your independence. Nine of Pentacles. All right, that's as much as I want to tap in there, okay? I hope that was helpful for that extra tap in. I needed to do that as soon as I saw that. Oh, I didn't clarify that one. For some of you, that will get a little bit more specific than I needed to, you know, but for the ones that really needed it, I needed to get into that for you, okay? There could have been some cheating or some addiction issues here or something that's off here, okay, Capricorn, on the self care aisle that is like screaming at you to go into that mountain, okay? You're a goat, so you can cross that mountain, okay? All right, take a look at the if you have Neptune in Sagittarius, okay, which Neptune was in Sagittarius through the 70s and part of the 80s, through part of the 70s and 80s, couldn't give you the exact dates off my head, okay? Take a look at anything, okay, when Jupiter is in Aries, when Jupiter goes by that, if you have a lot of aspects in Sagittarius, okay, when Jupiter goes by that, it can expand that, okay? So it can expand that Neptune, which can be a lot of creativity and higher spirituality, or it can also be drowning in the depths, disillusionment, okay, drinking, overdoing at anything, okay? So these issues can pop up if they've been an issue for you before, okay? So look at where Sagittarius rules for you, okay? Where its placement is, all right? And definitely watch for that transit of Jupiter Neptune, okay? Because it's gonna highlight these issues that are coming up for this self-care goat thing. For some reason, I'm just getting this feeling for you. Yeah, a Nine of Cups came out again, all right? So let me know how it goes, Cappy, okay? Because if you're a true if you're a true ascendant, then Sagittarius could be in your 12th house, okay, which is a hidden place. All right, so addictions can really pop off in the 12th house and be secretive for a little while until they blow out of control. So if you are a true Capricorn, okay, and you have Neptune in the 12th house, okay, these issues may be coming to the fore on a self-care aisle in one way or another, or just disillusionment about certain things, okay? And it looks like some of you have been through some sort of divorce mess here, okay? Or are going through that now or thinking about that, okay? But all of your aspects and hope here look very good for you to push forward. You are the goat. There's no better sign that can take on that mountain, okay? Bye. Capricorn, I also wanted to say that if you have your sun in the fourth house, okay, then this like mega transformation is moving through your house of home. Okay, so home life has been, and family has been totally transformed since Pluto entered Capricorn. Okay, you're at the tail end of that transformation right now. Okay, I just wanted to
mention. Hi Aquarius, I am here to do your weekly reading. These have been really, really intense and I didn't want to leave any of the signs hanging. Okay, I think it's just coming off of a lot of change and
last week's Pluto-Capricorn moon was especially intensive on multiple fronts and levels within families and networks of important relations, exes, female figures, Lunar figures, you know, things of this nature. It was just